Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will cover the best 200 multiple choice questions from the month of December. Now, a lot of you were waiting very impatiently for this video because a lot of you are unable to comprehend 1100 plus multiple choice questions that I bring to you every now and then. And therefore, what I do for your convenience is that I handpick around 200 questions. Now, remember that last month I brought this video to you a little earlier, and therefore the last week of November I could not cover. I will more than make up for it, and that is why the number of questions this week has become 233. So I hope you are patient. It will be a long video, I think around 2 hours. I will not reduce the quality of my explanation, and therefore video will be very long. We have launched a lot of pen drive courses recently, like for example philosophy optional for UPSC, and we have also launched individual GS and mains and optional courses for UPSC. Just go to our website studyiq.com, and we have also launched test series for CHSL and SSC CGL. So that is something to look forward to. Just go to our website or dial one of the three numbers if you want to gain any knowledge about the courses. You can follow me on Instagram. I spend 30 minutes every day to answer your queries, and I receive like hundreds of queries, but I make sure that I reply to each and every query. Or you can follow me on Twitter. That is my ID, gauravgarg888. Please note that each and every video that I upload, I put its link on Twitter, and therefore you will not miss any notification if you follow me on Twitter, or just go to our Telegram group. So let's begin. Who has been appointed as the first ever female ambassador of UK, United Kingdom, to United Nations? So who has been sent from UK to UN? For the first time, a female has been sent. Her name is Karen Pierce. Now, there is one question which is equally important, which is that there is a lady called Sarah Clark. She has become the first black rod. Now, what is the meaning of black rod? It is a position in the House of Lords. House of Lords is very similar to what we have in India, Rajya Sabha. It is the upper house. In India, upper house is Rajya Sabha, lower house is Lok Sabha in the Indian Parliament. And the Indian Parliament is very similar to the British Parliament. British Parliament is also called Westminster Parliament. Westminster Parliament, and they also have a House of Commons, which is the lower house, very similar to Lok Sabha that we have. And black rod, first black rod is Sarah Clark. Now, two or three questions more. Who is India's ambassador to UN, if I ask you? His name is Sayyed Akbaruddin. Sayyed Akbaruddin is the new, is the India's ambassador to United Nations. And you should know one more, that is America's ambassador to UN. Her name is Nikki Haley. Nikki Haley, her original name was Nimrat Randhawa, but now she is known as Nikki Haley. And United Nations is headquartered in New York, the same place where we have the headquarter of UNICEF. And UK, four countries together we call UK. Scotland plus Wales plus England plus Northern Ireland. England's capital is London, Wales' capital is Cardiff, Scotland's capital is Edinburgh. However, Scotland also has a very beautiful city called Glasgow. So I suppose that's it for this question. India recently conducted the tri-service military exercise called DANX at which place? It was conducted in Andaman and Nicobar. Andaman and Nicobar is a group of islands in the Bay of Bengal. Very similar to Lakshadweep, but Lakshadweep is in Arabian Sea. That is the difference. So Lakshadweep is to the western side of the peninsular India, and Andaman Nicobar is to the eastern side. Andaman Nicobar capital is Port Blair. It has cellular jail. It has two important volcanoes. See, India only has two volcanoes, and both the volcanoes are present at Andaman Nicobar. So the name of the volcanoes is, first is Narcon Dam, N-A-R-C-O-N-D-M, and the second is called Barren Island, B-A-R-R-E-N. Barren Island is the name of the volcano, and Narcon Dam also. So Port Blair is the capital. We did DANX. Now there are 7 or 8 more exercises that you need to remember. First is IMSAREX. It was conducted by Indian Ocean Naval Symposium, and it was held in Bangladesh. Vigilante Ace. It was conducted by South Korea and US, keeping an eye on North Korea, the mutual enemy. And South Korea, it was conducted at South Korea. Ajay Warrior. It's an exercise between India and United Kingdom. It was conducted at Bikaner. Bikaner is in Rajasthan. And Flag 4. Flag 4 was conducted by four strong countries, United Arab Emirates, United States, United Kingdom, and France. It was conducted in Abu Dhabi, which is the capital of UAE. Then there is an exercise called Aquavarin. It was conducted between India and Maldives. It was conducted at Belgavi. and Naseem Al-Bahar was conducted between Indian Navy and Oman Navy. It was conducted in Oman. Capital of Oman is Muscat. Then there is an exercise called Hamesha Vijayi, which basically means forever victorious. It was conducted by the Indian Army in Badmer and Jaisalmer in Rajasthan. Now, with South Korea, Uttar Pradesh has recently conducted done a MOU for development of in various sectors. And you should know our Indian military's three important people. So first is Army Chief Bipin Rawat. Then we have Navy Admiral Sunil Lamba. And third is Air Chief Marshal, that is B.S. Dhanoa. And our Defense Minister is Nirmala Sitharaman. Please note, Nirmala Sitharaman is the first full-time Defense Minister of India. Indira Gandhi, she was the Prime Minister of India. She held defense portfolio extra, but full-time Defense Minister is Nirmala Sitharaman. E. Chandrasekharan Nair, he passed away. He was a famous what? So he was a politician from CPIM party, Communist Party of India Marxist. So the answer is politician. Now let me tell you something interesting. There are only two states in India right now where we have the CPIM government. One is Kerala and the other is Tripura. Tripura CM is Manik Sarkar and governor is Tathagat Roy. And Kerala governor is P. Satashivam and CM is Pinarayi Vijayan. It is called Communist Party of India Marxist, or you can say leftist. So he was a politician. Now these are important people who expired or died in the month of December 2017. I have made a table so that it's very, very easy for you. Ja Ra Sundareshan was a writer and his pseudonym was Bhakkiyam Ramasamy. Lalji Singh, he was a scientist. He was known as father of DNA fingerprinting India. What is DNA? See, DNA is the genetic material. It is called deoxyribonucleic acid. And when the DNA condenses in a body, it is called a chromosome. And one small part of chromosome is called a gene. So what you actually inherit from your parents is a gene. That is why it is called unit of inheritance. Now, the father of DNA fingerprinting across the world is Alec Jeffrey. A-L-E-C, Alec Jeffrey. J-E-F-F-R-E-Y. However, in India, we call father of DNA fingerprinting as Lalji Singh. Batuk Gatani was a journalist. He is no more now. Lalu Chiba, freedom fighter from South Africa. Om Prakash Saraf, politician and journalist. Pandit Narayan Rao Bodas, he was a great singer. He was from Gwalior School of Music. John Hendricks was a lyricist and singer. He expertised in jazz music. David Cassidy, he was a singer from United States. Todapuza Vasanti, actor from Malayalam industry. Adarsh Seen Anand was a jurist. He was the 29th Chief Justice of India. Right now, the Chief Justice that we have, his name is Deepak Mishra. And he is the 45th Chief Justice of India. Kalabhavan Abhi was an actor representing Malayalam industry. So Kalabhavan Abhi and Todapuzhi Vasanti, both were Malayalam industry actors. Then we have Shrirupa Bos Mukherjee, who was a cricketer. Saraswati Tripathi was a freedom fighter from Odisha. In fact, let me tell you that the first freedom struggle was not the 1857 struggle as is taught in the textbook. Rather, it was 40 years before in 1817. It is called the Paika Rebellion or Paika Bidro, as they say in Odia. Paika Rebellion was in 1817. In fact, the Ministry of Human Resource Development has agreed to include Paika Rebellion as the first official freedom struggle from the curriculum starting March 2018. Adityan, he was a music director. Shashi Kapoor, the great actor. Johnny Hallyday was a singer from France. Ali Abdullah Salehi is the former president from Yemen. Yemen right now is having one of the worst humanitarian crises in the form of famine. And Yemen is fighting Saudi Arabia. However, in Yemen, there are Houthis who are backed by the Iran establishment. Keely Smith is a singer from United States. Banwarilal Joshi was the governor of two Indian states. He was the governor of Uttar Pradesh and he was the lieutenant or lieutenant governor of Delhi. Robbie Malinga is a singer from South Africa or was a singer from South Africa. Partha Mukhopadhyay is an actor. Bruce McCandless, astronaut, and he was the first person to walk untethered in space. Bob Givens was an animator who created the famous cartoon character called Bugs Bunny. Ashok Mattu, he was a sports administrator and he was the first president of organization called Hockey India that came into being in 2009. Chaudhary Prem Singh was a politician and Neeraj Vora, who directed and acted in many great movies like Fir Hera Feri and tons of movies. He was an actor, director. Ravi Shankar Pal was a writer. So all of these people, they departed to their heavenly abode. Not exactly heavenly abode, that depends on their karma, but whatever. So which state won the gold medal for the best state pavilion at the 37th India International Trade Fair, IITF? See, India International Trade Fair is conducted every year to showcase various goods and services by various companies, both from home and abroad. And the best pavilion was of Assam. Now, Kerala is always the favorite. Kerala has won Best Pavilion 8 times the maximum, but this time it was Assam in 2017. And Assam has a festival called Bihu Festival. And Assam CM is Sarbanand Sonowal and Governor is Jagdish Mukhi. Now in Assam, there are some important national parks like we have Sonai Rupai, we have Dibru Sai Khova, we have Nameri, N-A-M-E-R-I. Don't confuse Nameri with Namdaf. Namdaf is in Arunachal Pradesh. Nameri is in Assam. Then there is Manas, Kaziranga and Orang. There is of course Amchang Wildlife Sanctuary also, where there was an anti-encroachment drive that was undertaken by the government of Assam, which is a BJP government. And the best international pavilion this time was of Turkey. Turkey's president is Recep Erdogan and Turkey's capital is Ankara. There is a very beautiful town also in Turkey called Istanbul. And then there is Antalya also. Best ministry or department that had the best pavilion basically was the Ministry of Water Resources. Our Minister for Water Resources is Nitin Gadkari. Not just for water resources, he is also the Minister for Shipping, for Road Transport, for Ganga Rejuvenation, for River Development. So many portfolio he has. And he is a Lok Sabha MP from Nagpur in Maharashtra. Then the best central government enterprise was of Post Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited and CBTD. Now there are four more questions that can be asked from India International Trade Fair. The partner country was Vietnam. Okay, capital of Vietnam is Hanoi. Focus country was Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan capital is Bishkek. Partner state was Jharkhand. Capital is Ranchi. Jharkhand CM is Raghubar Das. And that's Jharkhand. And theme was Startup India, Stand Up India. I repeat, Startup India, Stand Up India. Now, remember Jharkhand, I was telling you something, which is that in the year 2017, see, there is a festival called Surajkund Festival, which is the largest festival in Haryana. And Jharkhand was the theme state in Surajkund Festival in 2017. Which state has announced to celebrate Lachit Divas across India to promote the ideals of Lachit Borphukan? Lachit Borphukan was a great warrior from Assam. And he was from the Ahom kingdom. He was a commander of the Ahom kingdom. And he showed his valor, his bravery in the Battle of Saraighat, which was in 1671. And they kind of overthrew Mughals. And so this battle is very, very popular in Assam. Battle of Saraighat. Lachit Borphukan was a great warrior. Now Lachit Divas will be celebrated across India. So that is what Assam has decided now. Which of the following payment gateway has launched Coinom? It is India's first cryptocurrency exchange. Which payment gateway has done it? It is Bill Desk. Also remember that whichever cryptocurrency it is, be it Bitcoin or Ripple or Raytheon or whatever, all of them use blockchain technology. And who is the CEO of this company called Coinom? It is Vivek Francis. Who has won the Sportsman of the Year award in the individual sport category at the Indian Sports Honours? Her name is, in the men and women, there were different winners. So men, it was Kidambi Srikanth, and women, it was PV Sindhu. And both of them have the same coach, Pulela Gopichand. In fact, Saina Nehwal, the great badminton player, she has also now made Pulela Gopichand as her coach once again. So Kidambi Srikanth from the field of badminton. Now there are some more awards. Sportsman of the Year, Team Sport, that is cricket, is Ravichandra Ashwin. Sportswoman of the Year is Mithali Raj. Mithali Raj is the captain of the Indian cricket, female cricket team. Coach of the Year is Vishweshwar Nandi. You should know something about him. He is coach of Deepa Karmakar. Deepa Karmakar is a gymnast who finished fourth in the last Olympics in 2016 in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. And she narrowly missed a medal. And one more thing, Deepa Karmakar, she does a very specific jump which is called Prodeo Nova. And Deepa Karmakar is from Tripura. That also you should know. Now, emerging sportswoman is Aditi Ashok. She plays golf. Emerging sportsman is Neeraj Chopra. He throws javelin. Inspiration honor went to Sania Mirza, tennis player. Transformational contribution to sport award was given to Abhinav Bindra. And rightly so, because in 2008 in Beijing Olympics, he won the gold medal. And he is the only Indian to have won the gold medal in Olympics in individual category. And team of the year was Indian women's cricket team. Although they lost to England, let me tell you, they lost to England in the World Cup final, but they performed brilliantly. And England team, they also won the under-17 FIFA World Cup that was held in India. And they beat Spain 5-2 in the finals. Now, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which is called MOHFW in short, Department of Health Research and Indian Council of Medical Research, they have recently started an initiative for the management of which disease? This disease is called hypertension or high blood pressure. It is called hypertension. And the woman you can see here, her name is Soumya Swaminathan. Soumya Swaminathan is the Deputy Director General in World Health Organization, which is a huge honor for India. And the Director General or her boss is Tedros Adhanom, TA, Tedros Adhanom from Ethiopia, which is an African country. Ethiopia's capital is Addis Ababa. Now, let me tell you something more, which is that government of India has kept certain targets for elimination of malaria. The target earlier, it was 2030, but now it is 2027. So malaria target is 2027, elimination target, I mean. Then HIV elimination target is 2030. Then tuberculosis target is 2025. Now WHO, it is headquartered in Geneva, and Geneva is in Switzerland. Which Indian bowler has broken a 36-year-old world record of Dennis Lilly to become the fastest bowler to reach 300 test wicket? By fastest, we here mean that in the least number of matches. Dennis Lilly was a great Australian fast bowler, and he took 300 test match wickets in just 56 test matches. However, Ravichandran Ashwin has taken 300 test wickets in just 54 matches. And who was his 300th victim? His name is Lahiru Gamage. Lahiru, L-A-H-I-R-U, Gamage, G-A-M-A-G-E. And Lahiru Gamage is a Sri Lankan player. Asian Development Bank, it has announced to provide a loan of how much amount to improve the rural road connectivity in 5 Indian states under the second Rural Connectivity Investment Program. They are providing a loan of $500 million, $500 million, and this will be used to build 12,000 kilometers of roads in 5 Indian states. You should know which are 5: Assam, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, and West Bengal. Our road transport minister is road transport cabinet falls under Nitin Gadkari. Now, Asian Development Bank, the highest share in this bank is of Japan, followed by America, followed by China. India has the fourth highest share in this bank. And this bank is headquartered in Manila, which is the capital of Philippines. And Mr. Takehiko Nakao from Japan is the president of this bank. Takehiko Nakao. Remember that. And Asian Development Bank is headquartered in Manila. Now, these are all the loans in the month of December that you should know. Germany is giving India a loan of 200 million euro. Now, everybody knows Germany is a very strong economy. There are no two ways about it. Very, very strong economy. Capital of Germany is Berlin, and Angela Merkel is the chancellor, and Frank-Walter Steinmeier is the president. Now, why India is getting this loan? For climate-friendly urban mobility 3 project. World Bank is giving a loan to India of $250 million for Sankalp program. And same, World Bank is giving India another loan, $125 million for Strive project. Again, World Bank is giving India 2 more loans, one to Uttar Pradesh for enhancing of their tourism project, $40 million, and $318 million it is giving to Tamil Nadu for the irrigation project. KWF Bank, it is giving the Northeastern Electric Power Corporation in India a loan of €20 million. This is the sign of euro. Okay, and this is the sign of dollar. Something like this is a sign of pound. So World Bank is giving a loan to Pakistan also for their energy and public finance, a loan of $825 million. Asian Development Bank is giving a loan to Reliance Power. They are Reliance Power company is building a liquefied natural gas project in Bangladesh at a cost of $583 million. And ADB is giving loan to Karnataka for building roads and highway. This is a highway project worth $346 million. Then Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank is giving a loan to China for their coal to gas conversion project of $250 million, and to India for Bangalore Metro, $335 million. AIIB is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, and Jin Leekun, he is the president of this bank. Jin Leekun, L-I-Q-U-N. Jin Leekun is the ex-finance minister of China, and Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank is headquartered in Beijing, which is the capital of China. There is another bank called New Development Bank. New Development Bank is headquartered in Shanghai in China. And Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, India is the second largest shareholder against ADB, in which India is the fourth largest shareholder. Which city recently elected its first woman mayor, Sanyukta Bhatia, in over 100 years? What is the name of this city? It is the capital of Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow. Now, Lucknow also has a metro, by the way. And Lucknow Metro is the first metro in India to have their own FM. And in over 100 years, they have elected their first mayor. Sanyukta Bhatia is name. She's from Bharatiya Janata Party. You can see her in the photo, this woman. Now, there were a few more firsts recently by women. Sarah Clark, I told you, first black rod in 650 years. Preet Dhindbal. Preet Dhindbal is the first Sikh mayor in US for Yuba City. Kanchanmala Pandey, she is the first Indian to win a gold at the World Para Swimming Championship. And Dominique Minier is first ever ambassador, female ambassador to any of any country to Saudi Arabia. And she's from Belgium. The capital of Belgium is Brussels, and Brussels is the headquarters of NATO, NATO. Yeah, so three more things that you need to remember if I'm talking about first females now. First ever female president of Nepal is Bidya Devi Bhandari, who is right now the president of Nepal. First ever female president of Singapore is Halima Yacob. And one more was there. Yeah, New Zealand. Not first, but third. Third female prime minister in the history of New Zealand is Jacinda Ardern, who is right now the prime minister of New Zealand. Who has received the first Lifetime Achievement Award of Chandigarh Literary Society at the International Literature Festival, which is called Literati 2017. See, this is for the first time that Chandigarh organized a literary festival. Chandigarh, by the way, is the capital of both Haryana and Punjab. It is a union territory and its administrator is VP Singh Badnor. VP Singh Badnor is governor of Punjab and his name is Ruskin Bond, the great Ruskin Bond. Now, don't confuse Ruskin Bond with Rudyard Kipling, who wrote The Jungle Book. A lot of people get confused between the two. Ruskin Bond's autobiography is called Lone Fox Dancing. Lone Fox Dancing. And his first book was Room on the Roof. And remember that in Chandigarh Literary Festival, our partner country was Canada. Canada capital is Ottawa and Canada's prime minister is Justin Trudeau and their defense minister is a Sikh, Harjit Singh. Now, Canada has in Montreal the headquarters of World Anti-Doping Agency, WADA. With which country did India recently sign an air services agreement? Our air, civil aviation minister is Ashok Gajapati Raju. Okay. And India signed this agreement recently with Greece. Greece's capital. What is Greece's capital? Athens. And Athens was the place where the first ever Olympic Games took place in 1896. And again, Athens hosted Olympics in 2004. And right now, our sports minister is Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore. He won in 2004 Athens Olympics a silver medal in the double trap shooting. Now, India has signed other MOUs also. With Italy, we signed in agriculture, infrastructural resources and medical education. Cuba, we signed in health sector. Colombia, we have signed for agriculture and fisheries. Myanmar, we have signed for development of the Rakhine state. See, Rakhine state is the state which has maximum population of Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar, which are facing a state-sponsored genocide. Morocco, we have signed in telemedicine. And Netherlands, we did first bilateral advanced pricing agreement, which is called APA. Now, Netherlands is also called Holland. The capital is Amsterdam. The people who live here are called Dutch. And remember, it is called the land of the windmills. And in Netherlands, we have a place called The Hague. The Hague, which is the headquarter of International Court of Justice. International Court of Justice, India's Judge Dalveer Bhandari got elected for a period of 9 years. And there are only 15 judges in the International Court of Justice. What is the name of the initiative launched by US India Business Council, which is called USIBC, to support the women entrepreneurs? This initiative is called WISE. What is the full form of WISE? It is Women for Women, Women for Women, Innovators, Social Leaders and Entrepreneurs. In short, WISE. I repeat, Women for Women, Innovators, Social Leaders and Entrepreneurs. And president is Nisha Biswal. Nisha Biswal is the president of USIBC. And India's Commerce Minister is Suresh Prabhu, who was earlier the Railway Minister of India. Which of the following organizations has formulated clinical guidelines on responding to children and adolescents who have been victims of sexual abuse? Which organization I'm talking about? It is World Health Organization, headed by Tedros Adhanom of Ethiopia, and Deputy Director General is Soumya Swaminathan from India, headquartered in Geneva. Which currency note has celebrated its completion of 100 year? See, this note is the 1 rupee note, the only note in India which is not signed by the Governor of Reserve Bank of India, but it is signed by the Secretary in the Ministry of Finance. And this note was introduced in 1917. And look, this is the note which was introduced in 1917. And it has the photo of King George the Fifth. King George the Fifth. So, yeah, that's all. Who won the gold medal in World Championship weightlifting competition in Anaheim in California in America, ending India's 22-year long wait. Why 22-year long wait? Because in the year 1994 and 1995, 2 years in a row, world championship was won by Karnam Malleshwari. Karnam Malleshwari is the same athlete who in the year 2000 in Sydney Olympics, she won the bronze medal for India. This was the only medal that India won in the 2000 Sydney Olympics. So her name is Mirabai Chanu. Mirabai Chanu, and she lifted 85 kg in snatch and 109 kg in snatch and jerk. Yeah. Who has been conferred with Third Indian Council for Cultural Relations Distinguished Indologist Award by President Ramnath Kovind? Now, Ramnath Kovind is the 14th President of India, and right now our Vice President is Venkaiah Naidu, and he is the 13th Vice President of India. So his name is Hiroshi Marui, and he is a Japanese person. He has contributed immensely to Indology in Japan. Japan is our good friend. It's an all-weather friend. Japan's currency is called Yen, Y-E-N. Capital is Tokyo. Prime Minister is Shinzo Abe. Demi Lick Nell Peters, she has won the Miss Universe crown. She is from which country? She is from South Africa. South Africa is a BRICS country, and president is Jacob Zuma. Jacob Zuma is the president. Now, there are some more beauty pageants that you need to remember. Miss World is India's Manushi Chiller. She is doing MBBS now. She will become a doctor very, very soon. And she has ended India's 17-year wait, because before her, in the year 2000, Priyanka Chopra became the Miss World. So after 17 years, an Indian has won the Miss World crown. Miss International is Kevin Liliana from Indonesia. She is the first ever Indonesian winner of any beauty pageant competition. Miss Earth is Karen Ibasco from Philippines. Miss Supranational is Jenny Kim from South Korea. Miss Universe is Demi Lick Nell Peters from South Africa. And Miss India USA is Shri Saini. Mrs. India, Pride of Nation, is Mayanka Patel. And Mr. India is Jitesh Singh Deo. What is the name of the first artificial intelligence politician developed by the scientist in New Zealand? Artificial intelligence politician. It is called Sam. And Prime Minister of New Zealand is Jacinda Ardern. Jacinda Ardern. She is only 37 years old, and she is the third female Prime Minister in the history of New Zealand. One more thing. This artificial intelligence politician is developed by Mr. Nick Gerritsen. G-E-R-R-I-T-S-E-N, Nick Gerritsen. And there is an artificial intelligence platform of IBM which is called IBM Watson. They can ask that Watson is the artificial intelligence platform of which company? The answer is IBM. Who has been appointed as the new chairman and managing director of Air India? So he will replace Rajiv Bansal. Before Rajiv Bansal, we had Ashwani Lohani, who then became the chairman of Railway Board. Then came Rajiv Bansal, and Rajiv Bansal will be now replaced by Pardeep Singh Kharola. Who won the men's single title of the 2017 ITTF Challenge Spanish Open Table Tennis Championship that was held in Almira? It was won by an Indian. His name is G. Satyan. G. Satyan. He beat a Japanese player called Kazuhiro Yoshimura in the final. Which company has commissioned India's first ever solar carport? This is commissioned on the rooftop of Unity One Mall in New Delhi. Which company I'm talking about? I'm talking about Tata Power Solar. Tata Power Solar, and N. Chandrasekharan is the chairman of Tata Group. N. Chandrasekharan. Uttar Pradesh government has announced to organize Ayodhya Mahotsav in which country from next year? It will be conducted in South Korea, and it will be conducted in two cities. One is Seoul, which is the capital of South Korea, and the other is Gimhae. G-I-M-H-E, Gimhae. South Korea's president is Moon Jae-in. There are important companies from South Korea like Hyundai, the car company, Samsung, LG, all these are companies from South Korea. The border between South Korea and North Korea, it is called DMZ, Demilitarized Zone. It is said to be one of the most dangerous places in the world. Now, there is one pitfall that you may face. There is a place in South Korea called Pyeongchang. Pyeong, C-H-A-N-G, Pyeongchang. Now, don't confuse it with Pyongyang. Pyongyang is the capital of North Korea. Pyeongchang is the place where Winter Olympics will take place this year in 2018, not in Pyongyang. And Pyongyang is in North Korea, Pyeongchang is in South Korea. The currency of both countries is the same, it is WON. North Korea's dictator is called Kim Jong-un. Who has won the Individual Activist Award of the Nelson Mandela Graca Machel Innovation Awards for 2017? He is from Egypt, and his name is Khaled Al-Balshi. Khaled Al-Balshi. Egypt's capital is Cairo. Egypt has this beautiful river called Nile. It has pyramids, which are the wonders of the world. It has a place called Tahrir Square. There are important squares in the world. Like, for example, there is Trafalgar Square, which is in London. There is Red Square, which is in Russia. There is Tahrir Square in Egypt. There is Times Square in New York. There are many. Who chaired the first meeting held recently for transformation of 115 backward districts for a new India by 2022? See, this 2022 is a deadline for a lot of things. Like Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi has promised Indians that he will double the income of farmers by 2022. Whether it happens remains to be seen. This is also the deadline for Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, which is called Housing for All, in which 6 crore houses will be built in India by the year 2022, 4 crore houses in rural area and 2 crore in the urban areas. Deadline again is 2022, and now the development, complete transformation of 115 backward districts for a new India by 2022, again the deadline is 2022. So who chaired the meeting? It was by P.K. Sinha, who is the cabinet secretary. There is a new species of gecko. Now, gecko is a lizard. It is a type of lizard. And this new species is called Mahendragiri gecko. It has been found recently where? It has been found in Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh. There are 4 more things that have been found recently. A frog called Odorana arunachalensis has been found in the Tali Valley Wildlife Sanctuary in Arunachal Pradesh. That is why it is called arunachalensis. Okay. Then wood scorpion, it has been found in Trishna Wildlife Sanctuary in Tripura. See, look at this word Trishna. It is not Krishna. Krishna Wildlife Sanctuary is in Andhra Pradesh. This is Trishna Wildlife Sanctuary, which is in Tripura. Leochalis shellari, shellar scorpion. Marine spider has been found. Name is, this is Bob Marley, named after the great singer Bob Marley in Australia. Blind fish called Schistura larkatensis has been found in Meghalaya, right? Andhra Pradesh, CM is Chandra Babu Naidu. There is a dance called Kuchipudi of Andhra Pradesh. And new capital is Amravati, which will be made a smart city by Singapore. And Meghalaya has 3 important hills called Khasi, Garo and Jayantia Hill. It has the beautiful Nokrek National Park. Capital is Shillong. Which of the following is world's first Sanskrit 3D film, which was recently screened at the International Film Festival of India in Panaji, which is in Goa? Goa's CM is Manohar Parikar. And governor is Mridula Sinha. This first Sanskrit 3D film is called Anurakti. The director of this film is P.K. Ashokan and actor is Vani Vashisht. There is one more director you should know. His name is Amit Masurkar. He directed the movie Newton. Of course, it did not win the Oscar, but it was a great movie. Newton. The role of Newton was played by Rajkumar Rao. Which country recently conducted a marine oil pollution response exercise called Clean Sea 2017. So basically what happens is there is a phenomena called oil spill, and this oil spill is a huge deterrent or detrimental factor for the aquatic life, aquatic flora and fauna. And therefore we must clear oil spills. So to check the preparedness for that, there was an exercise called Clean Sea conducted by India, and it was conducted by the Indian Coast Guard at Port Blair, which is the capital of Andaman and Nicobar. How much amount is India going to provide Afghanistan to help strengthen the public transport system of Kabul, which is the capital of Afghanistan? Afghanistan is a good friend of India, and we are providing Afghanistan a financial assistance of $2.87 billion, which is you can say 18 crore rupees, 18 crore rupees, yeah, for building roads in Kabul. Afghanistan, for development of Afghanistan, there is a process which is called Heart of Asia Conference. I repeat, Heart of Asia Conference is there, and the last Heart of Asia Conference, which was the 6th, was conducted in Amritsar, the Golden Temple city of Amritsar in Punjab. And Afghanistan's president is Ashraf Ghani. Ashraf Ghani. Now, India also gave a financial assistance recently to Myanmar for development in the Rakhine state, for stabilization, for establishment of peace process in Rakhine state. The amount was $25 million. And to Yemen, capital of Yemen is Sanaa, and they gave a medical assistance of $1 million USD. The 7th edition of the International Military Sports Council Military World Games is going to be held where? It will take place in a place called Wuhan in China, and the theme will be, the slogan will be Military Glory World Peace. Military Glory World Peace. And the mascot is a fish, Chinese fish called Bing Bing. It is also called Chinese sturgeon fish. And these are some of the upcoming latest events. Commonwealth Games this year in 2018, they will take place in April in Queensland in Australia, Gold Coast. Now, Commonwealth Games in 2022 will take place in Birmingham. Earlier, Durban was supposed to organize it, but then Durban in South Africa could not organize it for some reasons, and they were shifted to Birmingham in UK. Bad news for India is that in 2022 Commonwealth Games, shooting has been eliminated, and India has won 25% of its medals in all the Commonwealth Games till date in shooting. Winter Olympics will take place in Pyeongchang in South Korea. I repeat, Pyeongchang, not Pyongyang, in 2018. And Summer Olympics will take place in Tokyo in Japan in 2020. In Paris in 2024 and Los Angeles, America in 2028. Asian Games will take place in Jakarta, capital of Indonesia in 2018. Now remember, Jakarta is also the headquarter of ASEAN. It is the secretariat of ASEAN. FIFA World Cup will take place in Russia in 2018, that is this year. And in 2022, it will take place in Qatar. FIFA World Cup for women's will be taking place in France in 2019. ICC Cricket World Cup will take place in 2019 in England and Wales and in 2023 in India. Hockey World Cup will take place in Bhubaneswar, which is the capital of Odisha, and it recently hosted the Hockey World League also, won by Australia. Asian Athletics Championship will take place in 2019 in Doha, which is the capital of Qatar. Who has won the men's IBSF World Snooker Championship that was held in capital of Qatar, Doha? He is the great Pankaj Advani from Karnataka. International Day of Solidarity with the Palestinian people was recently observed on which date? It is observed on November the 29th. Now, can I ask you a very difficult question? The ambassador of Palestine to Pakistan, he attended a rally organized by Hafiz Saeed, the terrorist, UN-designated terrorist. And because of the Indian intervention, he was recalled to Palestine. What is his name? Can you tell me? And also tell me what is the capital of Palestine? Write down in comments. Now, these are some important days that you need to remember, and there is no alternative. You have to remember. December is one of the most important months for a lot of things, you know. So Constitution Day or National Law Day was celebrated on November the 26th. However, Law Day was observed also on November 25th. It was a two-day event. World AIDS Day is on December the 1st. And this time the theme was My Health, My Right. World Computer Literacy Day was December the 2nd. International Day for the Abolition of Slavery, December 2nd. International Day of Persons with Disability, December the 3rd. And the theme was Transformation Towards Sustainable and Resilient Society for All. Medha Divas, which is called Merit Day in English, was on December the 3rd. It is the birth anniversary of Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was born in Sivan in Bihar. He was the first president of India. National Agriculture Education Day is December the 3rd again. Indian Navy Day is December the 4th. World Soil Day is December the 5th. The theme was Caring for the Planet Starts from the Ground. International Volunteers Day was December the 5th. The theme was Volunteers Act First, Here and Everywhere. International Civil Aviation Day. Working together to ensure no country is left behind, December the 7th. Indian Armed Forces Flag Day, December the 7th. International Anti-Corruption Day is December the 9th. The theme was United Against Corruption for Development, Peace and Security. And International Day of Commemoration and Dignity of the Victims and the Crime of Genocide. You know, there have been a lot of genocides in the past. So those who are victim to commemorate that, the date is December the 9th. Human Rights Day is December the 10th. International Mountain Day, December 11th. The theme was Mountains Under Pressure, Climate, Hunger and Migration. International Day of Neutrality is December the 12th. Universal Health Coverage Day, December 12th. National Energy Conservation Day, December 14th. Please note that India's target for renewable energy. By 2022, we have to produce 175 gigawatt of renewable energy. That is our target. Out of this 175 gigawatt of renewable energy, 100 gigawatt should be solar energy. Atal Tinkering Labs Community Day is December the 15th, named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee, ex-Prime Minister of India. International Migrants Day is December the 18th. Theme was Safe Migration in a World on the Move. National Minority Rights Day is December the 18th. International Day of the Arabic Language is December the 18th. Goa Liberation Day is December the 19th. International Human Solidarity Day is December the 20th. National Farmers Day. See, this is very important. National Farmers Day is birthday of Chaudhary Charan Singh, ex-Prime Minister of India, who is the only Prime Minister in the history of India who never faced Parliament. December the 23rd is his birth anniversary. Just one day before that, Srinivas Ramanujam, one of the greatest mathematicians the world has ever seen, he was born in Kumbakonam in Tamil Nadu. His birthday is December the 22nd, which is celebrated as National Mathematics Day. And Good Governance Day is birthday of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, ex-Prime Minister of India, December the 25th, which is Christmas. Now, let me tell you something interesting here. December 25 is the birthday of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, ex-Prime Minister of India. But it is the death anniversary of P.V. Narasimha Rao, another ex-Prime Minister of India. Again, December the 25th. Which of the following sports authorities has been formally recognized now by Indian Olympic Association? It is Boxing Federation of India. And Boxing Federation of India president is Mr. Ajay Singh. Mr. Ajay Singh is the president of the Boxing Federation of India. Who has been honored with the Indian Film Personality 2017 award at the 48th International Film Festival of India that was held in Goa? He is none other than Shri Amitabh Bachchan. It was conducted jointly by the Ministry of Information Broadcasting, which is, you know, the cabinet minister for the same, Smriti Irani, who is also the textile minister. And both Smriti Irani and Arun Jaitley, they are Rajya Sabha MP from Gujarat. And gentlemen, you can see in the frame, he is Salman Khan, he is Karan Johar. And there are a few more awards also. Opening film was Beyond the Clouds, directed by Majid Majidi. And these are the important awards given here. Best film is 120 Beats Per Minute, directed by Robin Campillo. Best female actor is Parvati Thiruvoth Kotuvatta, movie Take Off. Best male actor is Nayul Perez Biscayard, 120 Beats Per Minute. Best director is Vivian Koo from Angels Wear White movie. And Lifetime Achievement Award was given to Atom Egoyan. And ICFT UNESCO Gandhi Medal was given to Shitij Horizon. Who has been appointed as the first chairman of the National Anti-Profiteering Authority? Now, what does this even mean? After the implementation of the GST, there is a need for anti-profiteering clauses. So, National Anti-Profiteering Authority is a new organization. And Mr. Badri Narayan Sharma, he is the new first chairman of National Anti-Profiteering Authority. There are some new important organizations like Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board. The chairman is MS Sahu. Now, remember, GST is 102nd Amendment Bill and 101st Amendment Act. So, whether they ask Bill or Act, Bill, is when it is passed by a Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha and signed by the President, then it becomes an Act. That is the only difference between Bill and Act. And GST will be overseen by Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Custom, headed by Mr. Vanaja Sarna. Who has been appointed as the chairman of 15th Finance Commission? 15th Finance Commission chairman will be N.K. Singh. And this commission will start from April the 1st, 2020, that is financial year 2021. Now, right now, we are having the 14th Finance Commission, and 14th Finance Commission chairman is Y.V. Reddy. And who is Y.V. Reddy? He is the ex-governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Who has become the first Indian man to win Asian Marathon Championship after winning the gold medal at the 16th edition of the event, that is 16th Asian Marathon Championship held at Dongguan in China? His name is Gopi Thonakal. Gopi Thonakal. Which state government has introduced Fish Pond Yojana for creation of additional water bodies for freshwater aquaculture? This state is Odisha. And the budget is 96 crore rupees. Odisha will create fish ponds for aquaculture. Odisha's CM is Naveen Patnaik. His party is Biju Janata Dal, BJD, and capital is Bhubaneswara. Odisha has a famous sand artist called Sudarshan Patnaik, who recently created world's biggest Santa Claus. And Odisha, well, there is a Simlipal Wildlife Sanctuary. There is Bhitarkanika National Park. There is a lake called Chilka Lake, which is very important. There is a river called Mahanadi. President Ramnath Kovind, he recently cleared an ordinance. See, ordinance is always promulgated when the parliament is not sitting, when there is no session, then ordinance is promulgated. And then it has to be passed in the parliament within 6 weeks by the usual route. Otherwise, it is held null and void. So, President Ramnath Kovind, he recently cleared an ordinance amending the Indian Forest Act of 1927. Omitting which of the following grown in non-forest area from the definition of a tree. See, if it falls under definition of tree, you can't simply pluck it. But now, bamboos have been omitted from the definition of a tree in non-forest area. So if it is a non-forest area, you can simply pluck bamboo and nothing will happen to you. No legal action will be taken against you. This is to promote ease of doing business and industrialization. Which airline has recently received Category 3B certification from the Directorate General for Civil Aviation, allowing it to operate in the dense and foggy condition? Not every airline has the license to fly in the dense and foggy condition, but this airline will fly, that is, it has been put in Category 3B. It is Air India Express. What is the difference between Air India and Air India Express? Air India Express is the commercial, it is the, what you call the, there's a word for it. It is the, you know, the cheaper version, you know. Like, for example, there is something known as Taj Vivanta, okay, and there is a Taj Hotel. So, Taj Vivanta is the cheaper version. It is the economy version. So, similarly, Air India Express is the economy version of, it is the budget arm of Air India. That's you can say. And remember, first made in India aircraft that has been enabled for civilian flights is Dornier 228. This is extremely important. Who has been stripped of the Freedom of Oxford Award? Freedom of Oxford Award is given by the University of Oxford. It was bestowed upon Aung San Suu Kyi, who is the foreign minister of Myanmar. But then in Myanmar, the genocide of Rohingya Muslims was going on and she turned a blind eye to it. She did not do anything, in fact, to provide comfort and to enable the peace process and stop the genocide. So she has been stripped of Freedom of Oxford Award. And Myanmar's old name was Burma. This country was called Burma a while back. And that time, when it was called Burma, the capital used to be Rangoon. But then it was changed to Naypyi Taw. So right now, the capital of Myanmar is Naypyi Taw. And the president of Myanmar is Htin Kyaw. H-T-I-N-K-Y-A-W. Which company has acquired Time Inc. Time Inc. in a $2.8 billion deal? This is $1 billion. Okay, this deal is huge. You can say it is like 15,000 crore. Huge deal. So Time Inc. has been acquired by Meredith Corporation. Now there are 3-4 more that you need to remember. Juggernaut Books has been acquired by Bharti Airtel. Bharti Airtel CEO is Gopal Vittal and chairman is Sunil Bharti Mittal. Tigo Rwanda is again acquired by Bharti Airtel. HDFC Realty and HDFC Red have been acquired by Quikr. And Blink has been acquired by Amazon. Amazon CEO is Jeff Bezos. Which men's and women's kabaddi team won the Asian Kabaddi Championship gold medal in Gorgan in Iran? It was won by Indian men's and women's team. And Iran is our good friend. Hassan Rouhani is the president. Tehran is the capital. Rial is the currency. And in Iran, India is building a port called Chabar. Which state's chief minister recently unveiled the official logo, mascot and countdown for the Hockey Men's World Cup 2018? It will be held in Bhubaneswar. So the CM will be Naveen Patnaik. This gentleman is Naveen Patnaik. And recently they hosted Asian Athletic Championship also. So for Odisha sports event, the mascot, this is the mascot Oli. See, in Odisha, olive Ridley turtles are famous. They are found at Gahirmath Beach. Gahirmath Beach, you will find olive Ridley turtle. And this mascot is Oli. Similarly, recently in Guwahati, we had the AIBA Youth Women's World Boxing Championship. Guppy, which is a one-horned rhino, was the mascot. And for FIFA Under-17 World Cup, which was won by England beating 5-2 Spain in the final, the clouded leopard called Kheleo was the mascot. President Ramnath Kovind, he recently inaugurated the 18th edition of the Hornbill Festival where? Hornbill is one of the most famous festival which is celebrated in Nagaland. So the answer is Nagaland. Nagaland has a national park called In Tanki National Park. And T.R. Zeliang, he is the CM of Nagaland. And Kohima is the capital of Nagaland. And Hornbill Festival. There is another festival celebrated in Nagaland. I believe in the first week of May. It is called Muatsu Festival. Muatsu. Again, a festival in Nagaland. And these are some of the important festivals which were celebrated in the month of December. Konark Festival was celebrated in Odisha. Konark is also a name of a temple in Bhubaneswara. It's a sun temple. Losar Festival in Jammu and Kashmir. Losar. And Jammu Kashmir, it is celebrated in Ladakh, which is a trans-Himalayan mountain range. And the district there is called Leh. Serendipity Arts Festival is Panji. India International Coffee Festival. Most of the coffee is in Karnataka. So it was in Bengaluru, capital of Karnataka. Mystic Kalinga. Kalinga is the old name of Odisha. There was a Kalinga war also, which Ashoka, the Mauryan ruler, had won. And after that, he adopted Buddhism. So it was in Odisha. Iran Shah Udawada Utsav. It is celebrated by the Parsi community. And it was celebrated only for the second time by them in Gujarat. International Sweet Festival was in capital of Telangana, Hyderabad. Tista Rangit Tourism Festival. Tista is a river that comes down from Sikkim to Bengal. It was in West Bengal. And Global Kokan Festival is in Mumbai. Which team won the Davis Cup? See, Davis Cup is the oldest tournament in tennis. This time it was won by France. It was won by France and it was the 10th Davis Cup title of France. And they beat Belgium in the final. Belgium, again, it has capital Brussels, which is the headquarter of NATO. Government has approved the launch of the National Nutrition Mission, which is called NNM. What is the budget? The budget is 9,046 crore rupees. And this budget has been allocated for 3 years. What is the target? Target is that government will reduce undernutrition and low birth weight by 2% every year. And they will also reduce stunting, which means less height compared to your age and weight. So there will be reduction of stunting from 38.4% to 25% by 2022. Which city is going to have world's first information technology campus for the persons with disabilities? So persons with disability, the world's first information technology campus, it will be built in Hyderabad, which is the capital of Telangana. Now remember that Telangana has a festival. It is a flower festival, floral festival called Batukamma. Batukamma festival is a very popular festival in Telangana. And they also have Murugavani National Park, which is in Telangana. CM of Telangana is from party called Telangana Rashtri Samiti. His name is Chandrasekhar Rao. And governor of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana is same. Who is the governor? ESL Narasimhan. Now remember, Telangana recently made Urdu their second official language after Telugu. Indian Railways has started new luxury coaches. Here you will get LED TV, you will get CCTV camera, you will get whatnot. So they have started these coaches in Rajdhani and Shatabdi Express. What are the name of these coaches? What is this project called? These will be called Swarna coaches. Swarna basically means gold in English. Swarna coaches and very, very latest, very, very modern coaches. Who is our railway minister? Piyush Goyal. And he is also the minister for coal. Who has become the first Sikh woman mayor in United States after being elected the mayor of Yuba City in California? California is one of the biggest economies in the world, not just US. And her name is Preet Didbal. Now, there is one more person I would like to tell you here. Ravi Bhalla. Why Ravi Bhalla was in news? Ravi Bhalla is... he was elected as mayor of Hoboken, H-O-B-O-K-E-N, Hoboken, which is in New Jersey, America. And he is also an Indian, Ravi Bhalla. Which state or union territory in India reported the highest crime rate of 974.9 against the national average of 233.6? So their crime rate is 4 times that of the national average as per the recently released report called Crime in India 2016 by the National Crime Record Bureau. Which state or union territory I am talking about? I am talking about Delhi. Delhi has the highest crime rate in India. And the highest cases of crimes against women were in Uttar Pradesh. Highest cases of cyber crime were in Uttar Pradesh. And the highest number of rapes were in Madhya Pradesh. If you talk about only rape, but there are other crimes against women also. But if you talk about only rape, then Madhya Pradesh has maximum number of rapes in 2016 also, in 2015 also. So this was the NCERT data. How many medals did India win at the 20th Asian Archery Championship that was held in Dhaka? Dhaka is the capital of Bangladesh and the currency of Bangladesh is taka. So how many medals did India win in the 20th Asian Archery Championship? India won a total of 9 medals. And this gentleman in the photo, his name is Abhishek Verma. Remember his name, Abhishek Verma. He won 3 medals. And there are 3 important Indian archers that you need to remember. One is Bombaila Devi, then Deepika Kumari, and third is Lakshmi Rani Majhi. Bombaila Devi, Deepika Kumari and Lakshmi Rani Majhi, in the exam, they straight away ask the question that, for example, Bombaila Devi is associated with which sport? The answer is archery. India has been re-elected to the International Maritime Organization Council for the next 2 years by bagging second highest number of votes. Who represented India at the assembly? Who represented India? India was represented by Y.K. Sinha, and International Maritime Organization is headquartered in London. London also has the headquarter of another important organization called Amnesty International, which works for human rights. And there is another organization called Transparency International, which gives Corruption Perception Index every year. And Transparency International, it is headquartered in Berlin. So remember that. Who has won the best boxer title in the World Youth Women's Boxing Championship that was held in Guwahati in Assam? Best boxer title was given to Ankushita Boro. She is local, she is from Assam, and she won the gold medal also. And remember, in this World Youth Women Boxing Championship, the mascot was Guppy, which is a one-horned rhino, which represents the cultural animal sensitivities of Assam, you can say. Culture of Assam, it represents the culture of Assam. And also remember that Mary Kom, who is 5 times world champion, 5 times Asian champion, and 1 time Olympic bronze medal winner, she was the brand ambassador for this event, Mary Kom. And Mary Kom is from Manipur. And one more woman from Manipur you need to remember, her name is Irom Sharmila. She is also from Manipur. Ministry of Defense has launched the Armed Forces Week from which date to which date? It was observed from December the 1st to December the 7th. Who has been named the Grand Champion of 2017 Global Innovation through Science and Technology Catalyst Pitch Competition at the Global Entrepreneurship Summit that took place in India, in Hyderabad. And daughter of Donald Trump, Ivanka Trump, she was one of the chief guests at this event. And her name is Ajayita Shah. She has got the Grand Champion of Innovation Award. And she has got it because there is a company called Frontier Markets. It is her startup. Frontier Markets is the name of her company. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the public broadcaster Prasar Bharati, which broadcasts Doordarshan, etc. His name is A. Surya Prakash. He has been reappointed. Earlier also he was the chairman. Now also he is the chairman. Which country has suspended its dengue immunization program after receiving warning for the vaccine Dengvaxia by Sanofi Pharmaceutical? So dengue, it is caused by a virus. But that virus is transmitted by the mosquito called Aedes aegypti. A-E-D-E-S aegypti. And there is no cure for dengue. We only give the supportive treatment. But now this company, Sanofi Pharmaceutical, it claimed that we have developed a vaccine. It is called Dengvaxia for elimination of dengue. And based on their claim, this country started a vaccination program to protect people from dengue. But then they received complaints about this drug and they withdrew their immunization program. This country is Philippines. The president of Philippines is Rodrigo Duterte, RD, who has been appointed as the chairman of the Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board. What is his name? His name is DK Sarraf. Does this name ring a bell? Sure, he is the ex-chairman of ONGC. Right now it is Mr. Shashi Shankar. He is the chairman of ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation. Now remember, ONGC, it was the most profitable company in India till last year. But this year it is Indian Oil Corporation. Indian Oil Corporation now is the most profitable sarkari or public sector undertaking in India. And our oil and gas minister, also the minister for skill development, is Dharmendra Pradhan. So DK Sarraf is the answer. Which state government has announced to set up an innovation hub called V-Hub, W-E-Hub, with an investment of 15 crore rupees? V-Hub and T-Hub, they both are the hubs in Telangana. So V-Hub is for innovation and T-Hub is for entrepreneurship. Who is the only Indian to feature in the Fortune's Business Person of the Year list, which ranks top 20 heads of companies? And he is the head of HDFC Bank. His name is Aditya Puri. In the top 20, that is the 20 business person of the year, there is only one Indian, and his name is Aditya Puri. He, remember that HDFC Bank has got the status of domestic systemically important bank, which means these banks are too big to fail. There are only three banks in India which have this status: ICICI Bank, headed by Chanda Kochar, then SBI, headed by Rajneesh Kumar, and now HDFC Bank, headed by Aditya Puri. And they can also ask you who was the first, that is, who is the number one in this list, because Aditya Puri was at the 18th position. Number one was Jensen Huang. Jensen Huang, and he represents company called Nvidia, which manufactures graphic cards. Which country has been awarded a certificate of commendation for its effort to combat illegal wildlife trade by CITES, which is called Convention on the International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora. Flora is plants, fauna is animal. This country has done a lot of work to protect illegal wildlife trade. Recently, they also started a campaign called Operation Save Kurma, K-U-R-M-A, Operation Save Kurma, which is to basically save turtles, and this is India. So India's Wildlife Crime Control Bureau, WCCB, started Operation Save Kurma. So 183 countries are a member of CITES, and it is headquartered in Geneva in Switzerland. What is the name of the cyclone that has hit India? Southern states like Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Lakshadweep, etc. It is called Cyclone Oki. And recently in Vietnam and Philippines, there was a cyclone called Tembin, T-E-M-B-I-N. Which actress has been appointed as United Nations Environment Goodwill Ambassador for India? Her name is Dia Mirza, and in her day, she was Miss Asia Pacific. Which state government has launched the Tendu Leaves Bonus Tihar? So especially in the tribal area and the Maoist Naxal affected area, if you collect Tendu, you will be provided various bonuses. This is to give them some economic benefit for their development. This has been started by the government of Chhattisgarh. Now, he is Dr. Raman Singh in the photo. He is the CM of Chhattisgarh. Balram Das Tandon is the governor. Capital is Naya Raipur. And Chhattisgarh, remember that it has three important national parks. One is called Kangar Valley National Park. Don't confuse Kangar Valley with Pin Valley, which is in Himachal Pradesh, or with Neora Valley, which is in West Bengal, or with Silent Valley, which is in Kerala. And then there is Indravati National Park is also here, and Guru Ghasidas National Park is also in Chhattisgarh. What is the name of the mission that is launched by the Minister of State for Health and Family Welfare, Anupriya Patel, that is aimed at tracing those who are HIV positive and to be brought under antiretroviral therapy? See, HIV means human immunodeficiency virus. human immunodeficiency virus. When it enters a person, that person is called HIV positive. And when the health deteriorates, the last stage is called AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. However, there is no cure for AIDS. But if a person becomes HIV positive in the initial stages, there can be some treatment using drugs like lamivudine, zidovudine, etc. And these drugs are obtained from the various trees and various other things. So the name of this program is Samparc. Samparc. And AIDS elimination program is till 2030. India has donated 500 metric ton of rice to which country recently? Because there is a famine in this country. This country is called Lesotho. And the capital of Lesotho is Maseru. India has donated 500 metric ton of rice. Iranian President Hassan Rouhani, he recently inaugurated the newly built extension of the port of Chabar. It is located on which area or which gulf? It is located in the Gulf of Oman. Capital of Oman is Muscat. And Chabar port is to counter the Gwadar port in Pakistan built by China. Who has released his debut novel in English, which is called Two? Usually he writes in Urdu. In fact, this novel was also written in Urdu. And this novel called Two is only a translation in Urdu, in English. His name is Gulzar. Now in the last question, remember two, three ports more. One is called Benghazi port. Benghazi port is in Libya. It has been recently opened after a lot of time. Then there is a port called Mombasa. Mombasa port is in Kenya. Very important because it has been in use recently. And then there is a port called Sitwe. Sitwe port is in Myanmar, which is a part of the Kaladan project. Very important. And then there is a port called Trincomalee, which India is building in Sri Lanka. And there is Hambantota, which China is built. China has recently got on lease for 99 years from Sri Lanka. So, which Indian movie won the Founders Award for Sustainability at the TVE Global Sustainability Film Awards that were held in London? London has the headquarters of International Maritime Organization and Amnesty International both. It is the capital of England. So, I am talking about Lipstick Under My Burqa. And you should know the director of this movie. This movie has been in news for all the reasons. Alankrita Srivastav. There were efforts also to censor this movie, to cut the scenes, etc. So, Alankrita Srivastav is the director of this gutsy movie. Who won a gold medal at the Asian Luge Championship that was held in Altenburg in Germany? And he is India's only luge player. He is only player. He will represent India in the 2018 Winter Olympics at Pyeongchang in South Korea. His name is Shiva Keshwan. Shiva Keshwan. Which of the following has been announced as the Cambridge Dictionary 2017 Word of the Year? So Word of the Year is usually which word has been used a lot in that year, or there is a spike in its use, there is a increase in the search on Google, etc. Different dictionaries give different word of the year. So this time Cambridge Dictionary's word of the year is populism. Populism basically means when a politician or anyone in position does what the public wants. That is called populism. As simple as that. Playing to the gallery. And Merriam-Webster Dictionary has given word of the year feminism, which basically means effort to make women self, what's the right word? Basically, for the progress of women empowerment, if somebody does something that all that science is called feminism. And dictionary.com gave the word of the year to complicit. Complicit means when in a crime, more people are involved. So we will say they are complicit in the crime. Oxford Dictionary's word of the year is youthquake. Youthquake means that the young generation of today is taking a lot of interest in politics. So there is a youthquake, like an earthquake, you know. And Collins Dictionary's word of the year is fake news, which has been in news this year for the obvious reasons. United States Agency for International Development, USAID, it has announced to launch a development impact bond, which is called Utkrisht Impact Bond for which Indian state? This state is Rajasthan, and this will be for the developmental works in this state. And Mark Green is the administrator of USAID. Mark Green. Rajasthan has Desert National Park, Ranthambore National Park, Sariska National Park, Bharatpur or Keoladio National Park, and capital is Jaipur, also called Pink City. Then Vasundhara Raj is the CM. Kalyan Singh, who was once the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, is now the Governor of Rajasthan. There is a nuclear power plant also in Rajasthan, which is called Rawat Bhatta. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, he recently launched Deen Dayal Divyang Jan Sahajya Scheme. Divyang Jan means the disabled. Divyang Jan Sahajya Scheme in which place? So this was launched in Assam and in Guwahati. He is Venkaiah Naidu and he is Sarbanand Sonowal. So it was launched in Assam. Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar, he has requested the central government to celebrate the birth anniversary of which leader, which falls on December the 3rd as Medha Divas or Merit Day. He is the first president of India. His name is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. He was born in Sivan in Bihar. And Nitish Kumar's party is called JDU, Janata Dal United. He has a coalition government with the BJP. Earlier, he had the coalition government with the RJD or Lalu Yadav's party, RJD, Rashtriya Janata Dal. Now, Lalu Yadav has been convicted in the fodder scam. India has launched a major infrastructure project in which country to improve the road connectivity? This they have done in South Sudan. In South Sudan, India is helping them to build road connectivity. Now, don't get confused between Sudan and South Sudan. They are both different countries. Sudan's capital is Khartoum, often asked in the exam. And South Sudan capital is different. Its capital is Juba, J-U-B-A. Sudan's capital is Khartoum, K-H-A-R-T-O-U-M. And South Sudan's capital is J-U-B-A, Juba. Who has resigned as the National Observer for Boxing? National Observer for Boxing resignation has been given by MC Mary Kom, who, as I said, is a 5-time world champion and 5-time Asian champion. Which state assembly has passed the bill for setting up an environmental studies university? This is the first such university in India which will have a dedicated environment studies. And this university will be built in Hooghly in West Bengal. West Bengal has Baksa Tiger Reserve, BUXA. It has Gorumara National Park, and there is Neora Valley National Park also. CM is Mamata Banerjee of Trinamool Congress. Which state assembly has passed Kapu Reservation Bill? There are three important dominant castes in this state. One is Naidus, one is the Reddies, and the third is the Kapus. So, Chandrababu Naidu is the CM of this state. This state is Andhra Pradesh. Who will lead the three-member committee formed by National Commission for Minorities to look into whether Hindus should get minority status in 8 states? See, there are 8 states in India out of 29 where the Hindus are in less number. So, whether they need to be given minority status or not remains to be seen. It needs to be evaluated thoroughly, and then a decision is to be arrived at. Now, which are these 8 states in India where Hindus are less? Lakshadweep, only 2.5% Hindus. Mizoram, only 2.75%. Nagaland, only 8% Hindus. Then Meghalaya, only 11%. Jammu Kashmir, 28%. Arunachal Pradesh, 29%. Manipur, 31%. And Punjab, only 38%. Maximum are 6 in Punjab. Then comes Hindus. So, these are the 8 states in India. And the chairman of this is George Kurian. George Kurian. And remember that the National Commission for Minorities chairman is Gayorul Hasan Rizvi, G.H. Rizvi, R-I-Z-V-I. And also remember that the Minority Affairs Minister is Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Moving on, which of the following has been inscribed on the UNESCO's representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity? Now, UNESCO is United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, which also gives out World Heritage Site. India has 36 World Heritage Site, and 36 World Heritage Site is the Ahmedabad city. Now, Kumbh Mela has made it to the UNESCO's representative list. Now, Kumbh Mela occurs at four places in India: Nasik near Godavari River, Allahabad Ganga River, Haridwar Ganga River, and Ujjain near Shipra River. That is Kumbh Mela. Who is going to lead the Indian team at the ICC Under-19 World Cup 2018 that will take place in New Zealand? ICC Under-19 World Cup will take place in New Zealand, and Indian captain will be Prithvi Shaw. And Shubham Gill will be the vice captain, or deputy captain as they say. Prithvi Shaw will be the captain. And remember, when I talk about BCCI, the CEO of BCCI is Rahul Johari, and the president of BCCI, Board of Control for Cricket in India, is Mr. Vinod Rai, who was once upon a time Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Which of the following has been named Time Magazine's Person of the Year? So, do you remember a campaign called Me Too? Now, Me Too is a campaign that was for everyone, for girls, boys, everyone basically. And you know, if anybody's modesty has been violated while they were young, or anybody has been raped or sexually molested, they can type Me Too hashtag on Twitter, on any social media like Facebook, etc. And these people were called the silence breakers, because they have finally decided to come out of the shadow in which they have been living under the ghost of the past, and they have tried to spread awareness about the same, even at the cost of telling about their personal lives. So the silence breakers were Time Magazine's Person of the Year, and there were a few celebrities on the cover like Ashley Jude and Taylor Swift, etc. India recently lost the semi-final of Hockey World League, you know, which was held in Bhubaneswar, to which team? So India was beaten by Argentina, but Argentina in turn was beaten by Australia in the final. So Australia won it finally, and this took place in Bhubaneswar, where the Hockey World Cup 2018 will also be played. India finished at third position. Mujib Jadran, he has become the first player in the 21st century to play international cricket. He belongs to which team? Now, he is born in 2001. He is only 16 years old, and he will represent his country, Afghanistan, very, very soon. So he will play, and in fact, he has already made his debut against Ireland. Afghanistan versus Ireland, he played for Afghanistan. Which state government has announced to introduce a Guru Shishya program? Guru is your teacher, Shishya is your pupil. So Guru Shishya program in all the districts will be undertaken in Rajasthan. And this is an attempt by the government of Rajasthan to bring teachers and teachers to solve the problems of their respective students. Which country's president Nicolas Maduro? He has announced the launch of a cryptocurrency which is called Petro, backed by oil reserve. Now, this country is oil rich. It is a part of OPEC also, Organization for the Petroleum Exporting Countries. All these countries have headquartered in Vienna. His name is Nicolas Maduro. He is the president of Venezuela. Capital of Venezuela is Caracas. And Caracas is the capital of Venezuela. It is a South American country. It is an oil rich country. Now, they have launched a cryptocurrency called Petro. In fact, 60% of the income of Venezuela is by selling petrol. Michael I, he passed away recently. He was the former king of which country? He was the former king of Romania. Romania is a European country. The capital of Romania is Bucharest. And he was the king of Romania during World War II, which took place from 1939 to 1945. First time, the Legislative Assembly of which state has passed a bill that says that if you are found guilty of raping someone below 12 years of age, then you can be even given death sentence. And there is rigorous imprisonment of 14 years of life imprisonment, rigorous, or 20 years depending on whether it is a one-on-one rape or a gang rape. So this bill has been passed by the Madhya Pradesh Legislative Assembly, and now they have sent it to the president for his assent. And Madhya Pradesh is taking strong steps, because Madhya Pradesh was the Madhya Pradesh topped the charts of NCERT in which maximum rape cases were there. So Madhya Pradesh has maximum rape cases in India in 2016 and 2015 both. There is a 6-member advisory group that has been set up by the Ministry of Finance, which will recommend changes to the goods and services tax. It was headed by which person? It was headed by Gautam Ray, and they are suggesting some changes in the GST to make it more compliant with the aspirations of the people, and especially with the micro, small and medium enterprises. Now remember that GST is managed by GSTN, which is called Goods and Services Tax Network, and the chairman of GSTN is Mr. A.B. Pandey. Mr. A.B. Pandey is the chairman of GSTN. As per the 5th bi-monthly monetary policy, SLR, statutory liquidity ratio, has been changed by what? SLR has remained the same. It is 19.5%, so there is a change of 0 basis point. Now, bi-monthly means every 2 months, one time there is a review of the monetary policy. There are 6 members in the Monetary Policy Committee, MPC. There are 3 from the Reserve Bank of India, 3 from the Government of India. And if there is a tie, then the Governor of the Reserve Bank of India can take the decision. So, you should know all the rates now. Repo rate is 6%. It is the also called repurchase rate. It is the rate at which the Reserve Bank of India gives loan to the banks. Then you have reverse repo rate, which is the opposite. Reserve Bank of India takes loan from the bank, and this is 5.75%. Marginal standing facility, which is required for overnight or very, very short term lending, is 6.25%, and bank rate is also 6.25%. Bank rate is the rate at which Reserve Bank of India gives loans to the commercial bank. Now, the difference between the bank rate and the repo rate is that repo rate is for short term, bank rate is for the long term. And cash reserve ratio is static at 4%. Since 2013, for the past 4 or 5 years, CRR is at 4%. And it is the amount of money that a bank has to keep with Reserve Bank of India in cash. That is the important word, in cash. Statutory liquidity ratio is the ratio that the bank has to invest in the government security. And it can be in the form of cash, it can be in the form of bond, equity, stock, land, anything. So this is what was done by the Reserve Bank of India in the monetary policy review. Which film has won the Best Asian Film Award at the 7th Australian Academy of Cinema and Television Arts Award that were held in Sydney? Sydney is a place which hosted the 2000 Olympic Games in Australia, and the best film was given to Dangal. Dangal is the story of Mahavir Fogart, wrestler, who fought against the norms of the society and let his daughters take up the profession of wrestling, which was very, very unusual in a place like Haryana, which has a patriarchal society. And the role of Mahavir Fogart was played by legendary actor Amir Khan. And also remember that there is a movie in which an Indian actor, Dev Patel, has acted. Dev Patel, if you remember Slumdog Millionaire, he played the main lead in Slumdog Millionaire. And this movie is called Lion. And the movie Lion, it won 12 AACTA awards, that is Australian Academy of Cinema and Television Arts Awards. 12, not 1, 12. So remember this name also. Government has recently set up a committee that will check why the non-performing assets are rising in the power sector. Power sector is one of the sectors in which non-performing assets are huge. In fact, in India, non-performing assets have now crossed 10%. And the bank which has maximum non-performing assets, public sector bank, is State Bank of India. Private is ICICI, and both of them are domestic systemically important bank. So, and against a lot of banks, in fact, more than 10 banks, Reserve Bank of India has taken prompt corrective action also to decrease the non-performing asset. Such is the huge problem. This committee was headed by which person? This committee was headed by Amitabh Kant. He is the CEO of Niti Aayog, National Institution for Transforming India, and Rajiv Kumar is the Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog. Which of the following has become the 23rd district to be included in the NCR, National Capital Region? So National Capital Region till now had 22 districts, 13 were from Haryana, like Gurgaon, Faridabad, etc. Then 7 were from Uttar Pradesh, like Noida, and 2 were from Rajasthan. So total 22. But now 23rd is again from Uttar Pradesh, and it is Samli, which is in western Uttar Pradesh. And remember, so therefore, in, you know, now 13 are from Haryana, 8 are from Uttar Pradesh, and 2 are from Rajasthan. Total number is 23. Union government has doubled the monthly allowance for gallantry medal won during the war and peace. Now, Paramveer Chakra awardee or his widow will now get what? Earlier, they used to get 10,000. Now, they will get 20,000 rupees. Paramveer Chakra is the highest award. It is the highest gallantry award in India during war. So, remember that. And if they ask you which is the highest gallantry award in India during peacetime, it is Ashok Chakra. So, Paramveer Chakra is given only during a war. And the last Paramveer Chakra was given to Captain Vikram Batra for his contribution in the Kargil war. And because after 1999 Kargil war, there has been no war for 18 years now. Not a full-fledged war. So, that is why last Paramveer Chakra was given to Captain Vikram Batra, whose role was played by Abhishek Bachchan in the movie LOC Kargil. So, Ashok Chakra awardee will get 12,000 per month. Kirti Chakra will get 9,000 per month. Mahavir Chakra will get 10,000 per month. And Paramveer Chakra will get, Paramveer Chakra awardee will get 20,000 per month. Who has won the International Children's Peace Prize for building a school in Lebanon for refugee? Lebanon's capital is Beirut, and it's a civil war torn country. So Lebanon, this person has opened a school for refugee. He himself is a refugee from Syria, and his name is Muhammad Al John. And he was given the award by none other than Malala Yousafzai from Pakistan, who is a Nobel Peace Prize winner. Now, Malala Yousafzai and Kailash Satyarthi, they won in the same year. Kailash Satyarthi has done a lot of work for preventing child trafficking. He is an organization called Bachpan Bachao Andolan. And his name is Muhammad Al-Jun. He's from Syria. Syria's capital is Damascus. And Bashar al-Assad is the president of Syria. US State Department has made the travel ban operational on how many countries? Post the approval of US Supreme Court. So as soon as Donald Trump came to power in November 2016, he immediately said that we will put a travel ban on 8 countries. Which are these 8 countries? There is Chad, there is Iran, which is the arch rival of America, so is North Korea, then Libya, then Syria, Somalia, Venezuela, and Yemen. So the answer is 8 countries. Now US has a travel ban. As per the World Social Protection Report 2017-2019 given by UN International Labour Organization, what percent of the global population has access to at least one social benefit? It is only 45%. There is 55% population of the world which still does not have any social benefit. Remember that. And 4 billion people in the world, they have no social security protection of any kind. The construction of India's largest solar floating plant has been completed. It has costed 9.25 crore rupees, and it has been done at the Banasura Sagar Reservoir. Now, where exactly is Banasura Sagar Reservoir? This reservoir is present in Wayanad, and Wayanad is in Kerala. So the answer is Kerala. Central government has removed the income ceiling of how much amount for Dr. Ambedkar scheme for social integration through the intercaste marriage, which offers a one-time incentive of 2.5 lakh rupees for intercaste marriage involving a Dalit. See, the rule is very simple. Earlier it was, if your income is still 5 lakh rupees annual income, if it is 5 lakh or less, and if you marry a Dalit, you will get 2.5 lakh rupees. But now this cap is done away with. So the answer is 5 lakh rupees. So now you marry a Dalit and you get 2.5 lakh rupees, as simple as that. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, on his name, Bhim app, which is called Bharat Interface for Money, was also launched last year. And Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar was the chairman of the drafting committee of the constitution. Which singer has recently been appointed as a global goodwill ambassador for UN Environment? Her name is Ellie Goulding. And UN Environment is headquartered in Nairobi. Nairobi is the capital of Kenya. First time, which state government has approved an industrial policy specifically for women entrepreneurs? And for this, they have kept a budget of 648 crore rupees in the next year's budget. Financial assistance will be provided by the state government, of rupees 15 lakh up to 1 crore at a subsidized interest rate of only 5%. So 15 lakh to 1 crore rupees you can get if you are a female entrepreneur and you will have to pay only 5% interest. This has been started by the government of Maharashtra. Devender Fadnavis is the CM of Maharashtra. There is a coalition government between the Bharatiya Janata Party and the Shiva Sena. Which of the following Gulf countries? Gulf is the Middle Eastern countries. They have formed a joint cooperative committee which is separate from the Gulf Cooperation Council. See, Gulf Cooperation Council has 6 members, which are Qatar, Saudi Arabia, UAE, Kuwait, Oman and Bahrain. And it is headquartered in Riyadh, which is the capital of Saudi Arabia. Now 2 countries, UAE and Saudi Arabia, they have formed something known as a joint cooperation committee. So the answer is 2 and 3. Central government has passed a notification allowing which of the following bodies to constitute a single member bench in exceptional circumstances. So basically this is a specialized court which takes care of all the environmental litigations. It is called National Green Tribunal. Now it can form even a single member bench in exceptional circumstances. So only one judge can take the decision on a particular matter. National Green Tribunal chairman was Justice Swatantra Kumar. Now it is UD Salvi. Umesh Dattatreya Salvi is the new chairman of National Green Tribunal. Which of the following has become the first treaty-based international government organization to be based in India? This organization was started by Narendra Modi and French President Francois Hollande. That time French President was Francois Hollande of the Socialist Party and Narendra Modi at the COP21 Paris Conference. It is called International Solar Alliance and its headquarters will be in India in Gurugram, which is in Haryana. How many gold medals did India win in the 10th Asian Airgun Shooting Championship that was held in Wako City in Japan? And Japan will also host Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games at this city only, shooting championship. These two are the most famous Indian shooters right now. He is Jittu Rai and she is Hina Sidhu. So India won total of 5 medals. 5 medals. Who has become the first Indian to win gold at the World Para Swimming Championship, which was held in Mexico? The capital of Mexico is Mexico City. Her name is Kanchan Mala Pandey. Kanchan Mala Pandey is the first Indian to win gold at the World Para Swimming Championship. First time, which state has launched a food safety on wheel mobile laboratory? That is, the food safety test can be performed by this mobile laboratory. And our food safety and consumer affair and PDS minister is Ram Vilas Paswan. Ram Vilas Paswan is a Lok Sabha MP from Hajipur in Bihar. And this facility has been launched by the government of Goa. Which Indian city has been named in the UN Environment Report of 5 global cities that have successfully tackled solid waste management? See, solid waste management is a big problem because our landfills are fast getting occupied and we can't burn them also because of air pollution. So the sites are becoming less and less. But there are 5 cities in the world which have managed which are doing solid waste management in a wonderful manner, as mentioned by the United Nations Environment Report. These 5 are Osaka, which is in Japan. And remember their names, this is extremely important. Then there is Ljubljana. Ljubljana is the capital of Slovenia. Then there is a place in Malaysia called Penang. And 4th is a place in Colombia, which is called Kajika. And the 5th is Alappuzha, which is in Kerala. Alappuzha, which is also called Alappi. It is in Kerala. So these 5 cities are the only cities in the world which are doing the solid waste management in the right way. Indian National Congress now have a new president. INC have a new president, Rahul Gandhi. So the heir to the throne is now Rajiv Gandhi. Rajiv Gandhi's son, Rahul Gandhi. Now Sonia Gandhi, she has resigned after serving as the president of the party of Congress for how many years? She served as the president for 19 years and 10 years in a row Congress was in rule also in her leadership when Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister of India. Now remember, Congress party was founded in 1885 by Alan Octavian Hume, A.O. Hume. Remember that also. Sports Minister Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore, he has announced to launch Khelo India program for the next 2 years, that is from 2017-18 to 2019-20. What is the cost for this program? And this will have under 17 boys and girls only. So, and also remember, all the Khelo India games will be broadcast by Star Sports in India. Star Sports has won the rights to broadcast Khelo India games till 2022. So that money will be 1756 crore rupees, 1756 crore rupee. Also remember that 2018 has been declared by the government of India as the year for sports. who has been appointed as the new executive director in Reserve Bank of India. So Meena Hemchandra, if you remember, there was a Meena Hemchandra committee also. So Meena Hemchandra, she resigned. Actually, her post, she has retired. Her tenure is now over. She will be replaced by Uma Shankar. FIFA has recently lifted its two-year ban from the football squad of which country? FIFA is the football governing body and it is headquartered in a place called Zurich. And Zurich is in Switzerland. Similarly, there is another place in Switzerland which is called Lausanne. Lausanne is the headquarters of International Olympic Committee headed by Thomas Bach. And recently, International Olympic Committee made Ban Ki-moon, the ex-Secretary General of United Nations, as their President of the Ethics Commission. Now, FIFA's President is Gianni Infantino. He is from Italy. And they had put a ban on Kuwait for 2 years, but now they have uplifted the ban. So the answer is Kuwait. The capital of Kuwait is Kuwait City. India has recently joined the Wassenaar arrangement, becoming which participating state, which numbers participating state. Now remember, the headquarter is in Vienna of Wassenaar arrangement, but Wassenaar is a place in The Hague in Netherlands, the same place where we have the headquarter of International Court of Justice. So India became 42nd member of the Wassenaar arrangement. Who has won his 5th Ballon d'Or award for the year's best player? Ballon d'Or is given to the best player of the year and it is given by a French magazine called L'Equipe. It is a French magazine which gives this award. It's a very important award and it has been won by Cristiano Ronaldo. Second position was Lionel Messi and third position was Neymar. Neymar plays for Brazil and he plays for a football club called Paris Saint-Germain. Lionel Messi plays for Barcelona Football Club and he's from Argentina. Cristiano Ronaldo plays for Real Madrid Football Club and he's from Portugal. He's the captain of the Portugal football team. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has inaugurated B.R. Ambedkar International Center at which place? This center was unveiled at New Delhi. At New Delhi. Who has been chosen for the 2017 Vyas Samman? It's a literary award. It was given for to this writer for her novel Dukham Sukham, which means happiness and sorrow. So this was recently given by the KK Birla Foundation to Mamta Kalia. And this award was started in 1991. President Ramnath Kovind, he has recently inaugurated the Naval Maritime Aircraft Museum in India. It is inaugurated at which place? It is inaugurated at Visakhapatnam. Now Visakhapatnam is in Andhra Pradesh. It is a coastal town. And Visakhapatnam is the third cleanest city in India as per the cleanliness survey after Indore and Bhopal. Indore is the cleanest city of India followed by Bhopal. And Visakhapatnam's railway station is the cleanest railway station in India. So remember that also. Which state in India has topped ease of doing business? Last year, if you remember, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana had topped this ranking. But this year it is topped by Haryana. Which state's cabinet has approved the solar power policy under which this state wants to generate 150 megawatt of solar power by the year 2021? Which state I'm talking about? I'm talking about Goa. And Goa has also started a scheme whereby if you want to set up a solar power plant, you will get 50% of the cost will be interest free. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Remember that earlier there were two separate ministries. One was Ministry of Housing, one was Ministry of Urban Development. Now they have been coalesced, they have been merged into one and it will be now called MOHUA or Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. They have signed an implementation agreement with Germany's GIZ company for a sustainable urban transport project in which city? Now remember, Germany is making KBC, Kochi, Bhubaneswar and Coimbatore as a smart city. So the answer is all of the above. Kochi, Coimbatore and Bhubaneswar. Similarly, CNP, Chandigarh, Nagpur and Puducherry, they will be made smart cities by France. In fact, Puducherry or Pondicherry was once upon a time under the occupation of French. And Pune will be made a smart city by China. And one more, Amaravati will be made a smart city by Singapore. India and Israel, they are going to set up a center of excellence in floriculture at which place? Now, floriculture means when you cultivate flowers. And farmers should do that to supplement their income. They will set up in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has a ruling party AIADMK and Chief Minister is Edappadi Palaniswami. And Tamil Nadu's state dance is Bharatanatyam and they have Mukurthi National Park and Guindi National Park. Two important ones are Mukurthi and Guindi, G-U-I-N-D-Y National Park. What is the name of the public procurement portal that is launched by Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Minister Giriraj Singh? Public procurement portal will bring in transparency and you know, the procurement policy, it has also mandated all the central public sector enterprises, CPSEs, to procure 20% of their purchases through this portal. it is mandatory to purchase 1/5 through online this portal. It is called MSME Sambandh. Which railway station in India has become the first energy efficient railway station in India in the A1 category, which is the highest category? This railway station is Kacheguda, and Kacheguda is located in Hyderabad in Telangana. It has achieved 100% energy efficiency in India. As per UNESCO's Global Education Monitoring Report 2017-18, how many Indian adults they can't read or write still in today's time and age? It is 266 million. So there are 26 crore, more than 26 crore Indians who can't read and write, Indian adults who can't read and write even in today's time and age. UNESCO's Director General is Audrey Azoulay, and she is from France. Which Indian weightlifter has created 3 national records in the plus 105 kg weight category in the World Weightlifting Championship that took place in Anaheim in USA? His name is Gurdeep Singh, and even after creating 3 national records, he finished at 13th place in the world. That shows how much high the competition is in the world. Our Health Minister JP Nadda, he is from Himachal. So Health Minister JP Nadda recently announced that India has become free from trachoma. Trachoma is a infectious disease of the eyes. It is caused by what? What is the causal agent of this? It is bacteria. It is a bacterial disease. Similarly, our Agriculture Minister Radha Mohan Singh, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Purvi Champaran or East Champaran in Bihar, he announced that Rinderpest disease has been eradicated from India. But Rinderpest is not a disease of human beings, it is a disease of the cattle. And remember, trachoma is a disease of the human being. So 2 diseases have been eliminated from India, trachoma and Rinderpest. President Ramnath Kovind has recently awarded presidential colors to which of the following arm of the defense force? It is submarine. And India has a very powerful submarine, which is a Scorpion class submarine manufactured by the Mazagaon dockyard. It is called INS Kalvari. It is a Scorpion class submarine. Kerala government has come out with a new ordinance raising the minimum age for liquor consumption from 21 to what? So Kerala government is under immense pressure from the various NGOs, etc., who are calling for a blanket ban on consumption of liquor. But Kerala government has acted, they have taken the middle path. They have increased the minimum age for liquor consumption from 21 now to 23. So if you want to consume alcohol in Kerala, you have to be 23 years minimum. Which country has formally recognized Jerusalem as the capital of Israel? This country is United States of America. And remember that this has completely disrupted the peace process in the Middle East. So much so that United Nations General Assembly called for a vote, and India voted against Israel and USA. In fact, most of the countries, they voted against Israel and USA, thereby nullifying the effect of the of this announcement or avowal. Which state's CM, Chief Minister, has recently inaugurated Purvash Folk and Tribal Art Museum at a place called Barkul? Where is this Barkul? So this has been done by the government of Odisha near Chilka Lake. Chilka Lake is the largest lagoon lake, saltwater lake in India. Next question is, the world's largest lithium-ion battery has begun providing electricity into the power grid in South Australia. This project has been commissioned by which company? You can see this, what looks like a building, this much large, it is the lithium-ion battery, and it is providing electricity to South Australia. This project has been built by 2 companies, Tesla and Neon. So the answer is 3 and 4, and Neon is a French company. The trial operations of the world's biggest automated container terminal have begun where? So this is basically a port, right? And here the loading and unloading of the containers can be done automatically without need for manpower. This is world's largest, biggest automated container terminal. It has begun functioning in Shanghai in China. Remember that? Which state government has announced cash reward for Gram Panchayat and urban local bodies which make their areas free of plastic? Plastic is like a menace for the mankind these days. The deepest of oceans are being plagued with a lot of plastic, and a lot of plastic is being dumped into the oceans, which is affecting the aquatic flora and fauna. So which state government has announced that if you get rid of plastic, the Gram Panchayats will be rewarded? This scheme has been started by the government of Maharashtra. And the scheme is basically that, there is a ban on plastics below 50 micron thickness. Remember that. Below 50 micron thickness is banned in many states like Delhi, Maharashtra, etc. And 3 villages will be selected from 1 revenue division each. And first prize will be the given, 5 lakh rupees. That village will be given 5 lakh rupees, which does the seminal work in eliminating plastic. As per the World Energy Access Report by International Energy Agency, India is on course to achieving access to electricity for all by which year? So according to World Energy Agency, India will become self-reliant on electricity by the year 2020. And there is a Yojana called Sobhagya, which means Pradhan Mantri Har Bijli Sahaj, Har Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. Sobhagya scheme says that 4 crore families, 4 crore households will be provided electricity by December 2018. That is the deadline. Our power minister is R.K. Singh. Who has become the highest earning musician of 2017 on Forbes annual list? What is his name? His original name is Sean Combs, but he is known as Diddy. Diddy. He earned a whopping $130 million in 2017. Second is Beyonce. Who has been honored with the 2017 Mother Teresa Memorial Award for Social Justice? Mother Teresa was a saint. She was officially declared a saint by the Pope. And right now the Pope is from Argentina. His name is Saint Francis. Mother Teresa was born in Macedonia. Macedonia's capital is Skopje. And Mother Teresa Memorial Award for Social Justice has been given to Priyanka Chopra. Priyanka Chopra. Priyanka Chopra, by the way, is also UNICEF's Goodwill Ambassador. Which country's Prime Minister Haider al-Abadi has declared end of the war against Islamic State Jihadist Group, which is also called popularly as ISIS or Islamic State, the terrorist organization? He is Haider al-Abadi in the photograph and he is the Prime Minister of Iraq. Capital is Baghdad. In fact, Iraq has done the maximum work in eliminating Islamic group from Mosul, Aleppo and various other places that were occupied by the terrorist group. Which state government has proposed to bear the cost of treatment of victims of motor accidents? Number one. Second, fire incident and third, acid attack. If there is any victim of these three, at private hospitals also, the state government will bear the cost. This has been started by the government of Delhi. Chief Minister is Arvind Kejriwal. On his life, there is a documentary called An Insignificant Man that was released recently. Deputy Chief Minister is Manish Sisodia. Anil Baijal is the lieutenant or lieutenant governor. Now remember that Delhi started Good Samaritan policy, which is that if you see a accident victim lying on the road and if you take him to the hospital, you will be paid 2000 rupees. That is a Good Samaritan policy. Which football legend has been honored by a statue in Kolkata? So this particular sportsman is beyond statue, I would say. His name is Diego Maradona. He is from Argentina and he helped Argentina win 1986 Football World Cup and the finals of 1990 Football World Cup. His name is Diego Maradona. There is another player from Argentina that you should know about. His name is Lionel Messi. Which country has announced to issue travel advisory from January 2018 to its citizen based on a 4-level classification system, making it more tough for people from outside to enter this country? This has been done by the government of United States. Now, three people are very important from United States. One is wife of Donald Trump. Her name is Melania Trump. Okay. She is also called the first lady. And then you have daughter Ivanka Trump. Then the vice president. President, everybody knows Donald Trump, but very few people know that Vice President is Mike Pence. And he is often asked in the exam. Mike Pence is the Vice President of United States. Foreign Minister, like we have Sushma Swaraj, United States have Rex Tillerson. In America, they don't call him Finance Minister, they call him Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson. And Defense Minister, just like we have Nirmala Sitharaman, America has James Mattis. Which state in India has become the first in India to offer its residents email ID in Hindi? Which state I'm talking about? And the email ID will be your name at the rate rajasthan.bharat. And this will be in the Devanagari script. So this state is Rajasthan. Who has topped Forbes list of the highest paid athletes of all time? This particular fellow in his entire life, he has earned $1.7 billion. That is like 11,000 crore rupees. His name is the great Michael Jordan. He played basketball. Michael Schumacher used to drive Ferrari car. He was a Formula One driver. Tiger Woods is second on this list and he is a golfer. David Beckham was a football player from England. Sri Lanka has completed the formal handover of which port to China on 99-year lease? This port is the Hambantota port. Sri Lanka was under a debt trap by China and this was a Chinese strategy to occupy the strategic Hambantota port in the Indian Ocean. And Trincomalee is a port to counter Hambantota that India is building. Trincomalee. Board of Control for Cricket in India, they recently confirmed that India will be hosting the ICC Cricket World Cup in which year? They will be hosting it in 2023 and 4 years before in 2019 it will be hosted by England and Wales together. Which state government has approved river linking project? Two rivers will be connected, Narmada and Parvati. So both of these are important rivers in Madhya Pradesh. And this is a project of worth 7,546 crore rupees. Also remember that this will provide irrigation facility in the crucial Malwa belt in Madhya Pradesh. Center government has announced to establish how many special courts. See, if there is a member of parliament, be of Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, or if there is a member of legislative assembly, also called MLA, and if there is a criminal case against them. In fact, in India, 1581 MPs and MLAs together, they have criminal cases against them. So they will be tried in special courts. So how many special courts have been, they will be set up by the government of India, by the judiciary? Total of 12 such courts, special courts will be there, where only the MPs and MLAs will be tried. Which country has become the first in the world to shut down their FM radio, frequency modulation radio, and move entirely to digital broadcast? It is Norway. Norway's capital is Oslo. It's a Scandinavian country, and it is famous for Magnus Carlsen, who is the world chess champion and world blitz champion. Which state government will launch Seva Sindhu? Seva Sindhu is basically a common citizen service portal to provide government-related services. So Seva Sindhu, as the name says, Seva means services. So government-related services will be provided on this website by the government of Karnataka. Karnataka has some important national parks like Ansi National Park, Banargatta, Bandipur, Nagarhole, Kudremukha. Then there is a Dandeli Tiger Reserve, and it has the highest number of tigers and highest number of elephants in India. Siddaramaiah is the CM of Karnataka. Which state government has developed a mobile app called Urban Genie? So just like you have Urban Clap, Urban Pro, and all these apps where you can find trained and certified technicians. For example, if you want to fit a tap in your home, or if there is something leaking, and so if you can find certified technicians through this app. The only difference is this app is Urban Genie, not Urban Clap or Urban Pro, and it is a government app. So this has been started in Telangana. How much amount of loan has been sanctioned by the World Bank to India for skill development program, which is called Sankalp? Now Sankalp has a full form, which is very important. It is called Skills Acquisition and Knowledge Awareness for Livelihood Promotion. In short, Sankalp. So World Bank will give $250 million for the same. And one half of it they will give for the Strive project, $125 million. The first ever electronic manufacturing cluster in India is going to come up where? See, electronic manufacturing cluster basically means that it will be like a special economic zone where all those industries which are specialized in manufacturing of electronic appliances will be set up. So it will be set up in Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh, there is a very important project which is called Polavaram project that is coming up in Andhra Pradesh. Which Indian has been felicitated with the inaugural Power of One award at the United Nations? Power of One, you can learn it from Lakshmi Puri. Lakshmi Puri. Which state government has announced 5 lakh rupees life cover for the pilgrims attending Ganga Sagar Fair? So Ganga Sagar Fair is held on the occasion of 14 Jan, that is Makar Sankranti festival. And if you do this pilgrim and something untowards or something like happens to you and you die, your family will get 5 lakh rupees. That is automatic life cover for all the pilgrims attending Ganga Sagar Fair has been given to West Bengal. West Bengal. Now remember that Ganga Sagar Fair happens at the confluence of Ganges River in Sagar Island, South 24 Pargana district in West Bengal. Japan has offered 8.4 million yen to India for construction of a vocational training center for poor women and youth in which state? Which state I'm talking about? There is a district called Baran district where this will be carried out, and this will be done by Japan. Japan in Rajasthan. Now remember an important thing, that ambassador of Japan to India is Kenji Hiramatsu. Kenji Hiramatsu is Japanese ambassador to India. Dhammapiya has been elected as the new Secretary General of the International Buddhist Confederation. Dhammapiya is from which state? Dhammapiya is from Tripura. Tripura, CM is Manik Sarkar, it has a CPIM government, and Tathagat Roy is the governor. Which state in India has become the first to operationalize a law that makes social audit of the government schemes mandatory? So social auditing means the public decides whether a particular government scheme is actually useful or not. This has been done by the government of Meghalaya, and Mukul Sangma is the CM of Meghalaya, and governor is Ganga Prasad. And Meghalaya's capital is Shillong, and Meghalaya has Nokrek National Park. Walt Disney has struck a 52.4 billion deal. This is like more than 3 lakh crore rupees. One of the biggest deals in the history of the world. So this will acquire which company? Walt Disney. Walt Disney will acquire Fox Entertainment. Fox Entertainment, and Walt Disney chairman is Bob Iger. These are very, very important questions. Bob Iger is the chairman of Walt Disney, and Fox Entertainment is Rupert Murdoch, the media baron. Rupert Murdoch. How many medals did India win at the Commonwealth Wrestling Championship that took place in Johannesburg in South Africa? India won 59 medals. Yes, 29 gold medal, 24 silver medal and 6 bronze medals. Who has created a world record for sailing solo around the world in 42 days and 16 hours? So I have heard around the world in 50 days, but this gentleman has gone one better. He has completed a journey of the world in 42 days and 16 hours only. What is his name? His name is Francois Gabart and he is from France. Cabinet has approved an agreement with UNESCO. Now, with the association of UNESCO, Indian government is making an international training center for operational oceanography. Now, where this will be set up? It will be set up in Hyderabad in Telangana. Uttar Pradesh government has announced to set up a research institute for the study of Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is our holy book written by Ved Vyas. And where this will be set up? It will be set up at Mathura. Which team has won the 2017 FIFA Club World Cup? Club World Cup is played between the winners of their respective continent. So from Europe, Real Madrid won the Champions League. Then that is why they competed against other continent teams. And they beat Gremio in the final. It was won by Real Madrid. The coach of Real Madrid is the French legendary midfielder Zinedine Zidane. Which telecom company in India has been suspended for eKYC process by the Unique Identification Authority of India? So I'll tell you what this company was doing. They played a smart trick. So anyone who did Aadhaar eKYC, electronic know your customer process, they took the details of that person and opened payments bank without their permission. In fact, it was the first payment bank to open in India. It was Bharti Airtel that was doing this fraud. That is why they have been suspended for eKYC process by the UIDAI. Union Cabinet has approved Muslim Women Protection of Right on Marriage Bill. So basically, if any Muslim man tries to give instant triple talaq to any Muslim female, he will be given a jail of how many years? He will be jailed for 3 years. Government has constituted a Central Advisory Council which will advise on implementation of the Real Estate Regulation Act, that is called RERA. It will be headed by Hardeep Singh Puri, who is our Minister for Housing and Urban Affairs. Which state government has signed a memorandum of understanding with Isha Foundation for conservation of river? This gentleman is Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev. He is the founder of Isha Foundation. And this gentleman is Sarbanand Sonowal, Chief Minister of Assam. So the answer is Assam. Assam has various rivers like Brahmaputra, for example. They all need to be conserved. Petroleum Minister Dharmendra Pradhan. He is Minister for Oil, Gas and Skill Development. Dharmendra Pradhan has inaugurated Eastern India's first compressed natural gas station at which place? CNG station. This he has inaugurated in Bhubaneswara. Which country recently hosted the first ever international wheelchair cricket tournament? Not only did they host it, they won it also. This country is Nepal. Their president is Bidya Devi Bhandari and capital is Kathmandu. Kathmandu is the headquarter for SARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, which has 8 countries as their member. Which country has recently become polio free? It was declared by World Health Organization, headquartered in Geneva and headed by Tedros Adhanom of Ethiopia. Which country I'm talking about? The capital of this country is Libreville. This country is Gabon. Bharatiya Janata Party BJP has won elections in Gujarat. It has been in power in Gujarat since when? It has been in power since 1995. That's a long time. So 22 years on the run. And they won Gujarat for the 6th time in a row. They won 99 seats in Gujarat out of 182. And they won 44 seats in Himachal Pradesh out of 68. Which city has launched a smart city card, which can be used to make payments for various government schemes, and it can be used as a valid identity proof? This is one of its kind, which is done by Chandigarh. And she is MP from Chandigarh. Her name is Kiran Kher. She is wife of Anupam Kher. Who has been named the British Broadcasting Channel Overseas Sports Personality of the Year for a record 4th time? He is none other than Roger Federer. He is a tennis player from Switzerland. And last year, in 2017, he won the Australian Open and Wimbledon. Lionel Messi, as I said, is a player from Argentina. He plays football for Barcelona. Virat Kohli is Indian cricket team captain. And LeBron James is a basketball player. Which state government has relaxed the age limit for applying to government job from 35 to 40? So previously, till 35, you could apply for jobs. But now you can apply till 40 years. Which state government has done it? It is the government of Rajasthan. Central government has approved to set up India's first National Rail and Transport University at which place in India? And it will be built by the Ministry of Railways. It will be set up in Vadodara. Vadodara is the old name is Baroda. It is in Gujarat. It is the headquarter of Bank of Baroda also. Expert Appraisal Committee of the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, they have given clearance to the Kaleshwaram project. Kaleshwaram irrigation project is a project in which state? And it will cost 80,000 crore rupees. So it is a project from Telangana, and Polavaram is a project of Andhra Pradesh. Who has won Mr. India title? His name is Jitesh Singh Deo, and now he will represent India at the Mr. World event in 2020. Ministry of Railways has announced to make all the railway stations in India 100% LED lit by which date? This will be done within next 3 months. So by March 2018, you can expect all the railway stations in India to be lit by LED bulbs, light emitting diode bulb, which consume significantly less electricity than the old incandescent bulbs. Now remember, there is a scheme also which is called Ujala, which means Unnat Jyoti for affordable LEDs for all, where the government's target is they will replace 77 crore bulbs in India by LED bulbs. Rajya Sabha recently passed the Indian Institute of Management Bill 2017. It confers the status of institution of national importance on how many IIMs. IIMs are called Indian Institute of Management, like IIM Ahmedabad, IIM Bengaluru, IIM Kolkata, Shillong, Lucknow, and so on. Now remember one important thing, that IIMs cannot give MBA degree right now because they are not covered in the or under the ambit of institution of national importance. Now they give degree called PGDM, that is postgraduate diploma in management. So anybody who does MBA, even from IIM Ahmedabad, which is ranked number one MBA college in the country, he will get only a PGDM degree. So now they will be able to give the MBA degree. So total 20 IIMs will be made institutions of national importance. What is the name of the 1400 crore rupees project launched by our Minister of Communication with independent charge Manoj Sinha? And this project is basically that the unbanked rural population will be financially included, because financial inclusion is still not there. Out of 6 lakh plus villages, only 50,000 odd villages in India, they have banks. So this scheme will be called Darpan. And the full form of Darpan is, well, there is always a full form, Digital Advancement of Rural Post Office for a New India. In short, Darpan. Who has been appointed as the chairman of National Green Tribunal to succeed the retiring Justice Swatantra Kumar, who has been chairman for a long time? The new chairman of NGT will be Justice Umesh Dattatreya Salvi. Competition Commission of India has approved merger of Bharat Financial Inclusion with which bank? Bharat Financial Inclusion will be now merged with IndusInd Bank. IndusInd Bank Managing Director is Ramesh Sobti. And Competition Commission of India chairman is D.K. Sikri. Full name is Devender Kumar Sikri. Which two empires will be the empires, Indian Empire, in the Hockey World Cup that will take place in 2018 in Bhubaneswar? Two empires have been named by the International Hockey Federation, FIH. Remember that FIH president is also an Indian. His name is Narendra Batra. Narendra Batra is the president of International Hockey Federation. And the two empires are, one is Javed Sheikh, and second is Raghu Prasad. So the answer is 2 and 3. Which state government has banned kite flying thread of nylon, plastic or any other synthetic material? They have also banned Chinese threads. If you use Chinese threads for flying kites, it is not allowed. It has been banned by the government of Punjab. Chandigarh is the capital. VP Singh Badnor is the governor. Captain Amrinder Singh is the CM. Which railway, central, northern, eastern or southern, has launched Railway Mitra, R Mitra, for security of passenger? It is a mobile app. So it has been launched by Eastern Railway. And remember, Railway Protection Force Director General is Dharmender Kumar, DK. Now there is a village in India which has got electricity for the first time. It is called Jokapat village. First time since 1947, 15th August, it has got electricity. It is in which state? It is in Chhattisgarh. India's first and only design university, which is called the World University of Design, has been recently opened where? It has been opened in Sonipat, and Sonipat is in Haryana. Sameep initiative has been launched by which ministry? Now what does Sameep stand for? It stands for Students and MEA Engagement Program. MEA means Ministry of External Affairs. So the answer is Ministry of External Affairs. Sushma Swaraj is the Foreign Minister of India. Which sport has been excluded from the events of 2022 Commonwealth Games that will be taking place in Birmingham? Birmingham is in UK. Earlier, 2022 Commonwealth Games were supposed to take place in Durban in South Africa. Now they will be in Birmingham. Shooting has been excluded, which is a bad news for India, because 25% of our medals, in fact, let me tell you exact figure. I'm forgetting the exact number, but yeah, you can say 25% of the medals India used to win in shooting. Which of the following has become the first Indian city to have its own logo? It is called Bengaluru, and the tagline is Bengaluru BU. Bengaluru BU. Bengaluru has Indian Institute of Science. It is called Science City. It has, you know, ISRO headquarter, Indian Space Research Organization headquarter. Therefore, it is called Space City. It is called IT City and so on. Who has been appointed as the new executive director of UNICEF? Earlier, it was Anthony Lake. Now, it is Henrietta Fore. Audrey Azoulay is from UNESCO. Henrietta Fore is from United States of America. She will be the new director of UNICEF. UNICEF is headquartered in New York. Airport Authority of India has given its approval. Now, there will be India's first runway on a sea bridge at which airport? And you can see here, this is the bridge and there will be a runway made on this. So, this will be on the Agati Island, which is in Lakshadweep. Minicoy Island is the largest island of Lakshadweep and capital of Lakshadweep is Kavarati. Lakshadweep is in the Arabian Sea. Which state government has launched a free household power connection scheme, which is called Prakash Hai Toh Vikas Hai, which means if you have electricity, you have development. And this particular person, he is the power minister of this state. His name is Shrikant Sharma. I'm talking about Uttar Pradesh. India is going to establish a center of excellence in information technology at Al Azhar University. Where is this university exactly? This university is in Egypt. Which state government has signed a memorandum of understanding with South Korea to enhance cooperation in the field of culture, skill development, farming and tourism? This state is Uttar Pradesh. And remember, Tourism Minister of India is KJ Alphonse, Culture Minister is Dr. Mahesh Sharma, Skill Development Minister is Dharmendra Pradhan, Agriculture Minister is Radha Mohan Singh. Who has topped the Forbes India Celebrity 100 list for second time in a row? He is Salman Khan, he is number 1, Shah Rukh Khan is number 2, Virat Kohli is number 3. Salman Khan's total earning was 232 crore rupees in 2017. Who headed the select committee of the Rajya Sabha, which has recommended that the Motor Vehicle Amendment Bill of 2017 should be passed without any modification? This particular select committee was headed by Vinay Sahastrabuddhe. Which Indian player has been named in both One Day as well as T20 ICC Women's Team of the Year? Only one player is such. Her name is Ekta Bisht. Which state assembly has passed a bill to award death penalty and life imprisonment to those dealing in spurious liquor if its consumption leads to any death? So basically, the problem is the drinkable alcohol is C2H5OH, which is called ethanol. Some people, they instead of ethanol, they make CH3OH, which is poisonous, which is called methanol. And therefore, the spurious or fake liquor can lead to many deaths. So this state can award death penalty if any, because of any fake alcohol, somebody dies. This state is Uttar Pradesh. They have also passed something known as UPCOCA bill. Which state has been recognized as champion state for recording highest growth in exports during 2016-17 financial year? In fact, their exports were 19,000 crore. They have doubled to 40,000 crore. This state is state of Odisha, which is designated as a champion state for exports. Which airline in India made a record for flying 1,000 flights in a day? Often this airline is in news for all the wrong reason, but this time for the right reason, it is IndiGo. Now, the president of IndiGo is Aditya Ghosh. Aditya Ghosh. And their 1,000th flight was from Mumbai to Kochi in Kerala. What is the name of India's first homegrown high purity gold reference standard, which was launched at the India Government Mint in Mumbai? It will be called BND4201 and you can check the purity of gold. Now, the full form of BND is Bhartiya Nirdeshak Dravya. Bhartiya Nirdeshak Dravya. Dravya means liquid and Nirdeshak means somebody that gives you direction. So, it is a liquid which will give you the direction as to what is the purity of gold. Who has been appointed as brand ambassador of English Premier League in India? He is Ranveer Singh. EPL is becoming very popular in India. Every person I talk to supports one or the other club of English football. Which country is going to host World Chess Tournament for the first time? They have already hosted it. It is Saudi Arabia. King Salman Championship, as it is called after the name of their King Salman. And there were two types of championship. One is Blitz and one is Rapid. In both, you have to think very fast. In Blitz, there is even less time than the Rapid. So, Rapid was won by Vishwanathan Anand of India. He is from Tamil Nadu. And Blitz was won by Magnus Carlsen of Norway, who is a World Chess Champion. Which municipal corporation has launched Atal Jan Ahar Yojana to provide meal at only 10 rupees, named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji? Lot of schemes are named after him, like Atal Pension Yojana, like Amrut, which means Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation, etc. So this is the South Delhi Municipal Corporation. As per the Rural Development Ministry of India, how many Gram Panchayat in India will be made poverty free by 2019 and they will be ranked also under the Mission Antyodaya? Under Mission Antyodaya. How many Gram Panchayat? 50,000 Gram Panchayat is the target to be made poverty free by 2019. who became the new chief minister of Himachal Pradesh. He will replace Veerbhadra Singh as the new chief minister. His name is Jairam Thakur and his Vidhan Sabha or Legislative Assembly constituency is Seraj, S-E-R-A-J, and he is from Mandi district and he is the first CM from Mandi district. Himachal Pradesh capital is Shimla. World's longest glass bridge. You can see, walk on it at your own risk because, I mean, you can see the bottom also. It's very high. It is 218 meter above the level. Qutub Minar, by the way, is 72 meter. So it is like what? Three times more, 218 meter. It's big. And it has been opened in China in Hebei province. Remember the name Hebei province, H-E-B-E-I. Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently inaugurated which line of the Delhi Metro? That is called DMRC, Delhi Metro Rail Corporation. It plies between Botanical Garden and Kalkaji Mandir. It is called the Magenta Line. And Arvind Kejriwal was not invited despite being the CM of Delhi. In fact, Yogi Adityanath was invited. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will become the first Indian Prime Minister in the last 20 years to attend World Economic Forum Summit, where it will be held. It will take place in 2018 in Davos, and 20 years back in 1997, the then Prime Minister H.D. Devegowda attended World Economic Forum Summit. And World Economic Forum, Klaus Schwab is the president. Klaus Schwab, remember that. The transport department of which state has won the Scotch Platinum Award for exceptional service, for exceptional contribution to this sector? It is the Madhya Pradesh Transport Department. Platinum is the highest award. Then is the Gold Award, or also called the Scotch Golden Award. And Golden Award is won by Telangana Municipal Corporation. Who has become the most expensive wrestler in the history of Pro Wrestling League? He was sold for 55 lakh rupees to Delhi Sultans. Delhi Sultans acquired him. His name is Sushil Kumar. He's a 2-time Olympic champion. So it is not surprising that he is costliest, 55 lakh rupees. And second costliest is Vinesh Fogart at 40 lakh rupees. Who led the Indian Air Force team, which has successfully completed Mission 7 Summit by scaling Mount Vinson in Antarctica? In Antarctica, there are 7 continents in the world, and Mission 7 Summit is basically, we will climb the highest peak of all the 7 continents. Like in Asia, we have Mount Everest. Like in South America, we have Mount Aconcagua in Antarctica. Europe, we have Elbrus. Tanzania, in Africa, we have in Tanzania, Mount Kilimanjaro, and so on. So this team was led by Group Captain R.C. Tripathi. UNESCO Cultural Heritage Tag has been given to the artisans of Panama country for their woven hat called what? This is a special type of hat which is built by the weavers in Panama and it has been now given UNESCO Cultural Heritage Tag. It is called Pintao. Indian Science Congress will be held where? So Indian Science Congress was supposed to be held at Osmania University in Hyderabad, but they are not hosting it now. It will be now be taking place in Manipur University in Imphal. Government has slashed the interest rate on small savings scheme by what? This is a very, very important question. Government has reduced the interest rate on small savings scheme by 20 basis points. So what will be the new savings now? On public provident fund, now you will get 7.6% instead of 7.8 because 20 basis point is the decrease. And on national savings certificate, you will get again 7.6%. On KVP, which means Kisan Vikas Patra, you will get only 7.3%. And Sukanya Samriddhi account, SSA, you will get 8.1%. Who has won the women's 25 meter pistol gold event with a new national record at the 61st National Shooting Championship? So she is the new national champion. It was held in the capital of Kerala, Trivandrum, also called Thirunandpuram. And she is a national record holder also now. Her name is Anisa Saeed. And Jitu Rai also broke the national record in the 50 meter pistol category. Who heads the Technical and Safety Standards Committee for the pot taxi project to come up on the 12.3 kilometer Delhi-Gurgaon pilot corridor? These are the taxis which don't need a driver. And it is a dream project of Nitin Gadkari, our road and transport minister. And there is a safety committee which will make sure that it is safe. And it is headed by S.K. Dharmadhikari. Second air corridor between India and Afghanistan was recently inaugurated with a flight between Kabul and what? See, there are two air corridors now. First one was between Delhi and Kabul. Now there is a direct flight India and Afghanistan between Mumbai and Kabul. So the answer is Mumbai. So this was the video. I'm very tired now. It was such a long video and so much explanation, so much energy, so much passion involved. Anyways, please share the video as much as you can with all of your friends. And during the course of this video, I did ask you some questions. So do try to answer those also. How do you like my coverage in English language? Please let me know and keep supporting the way you have in 2017. I hope 2018 will be even more fruitful for both you and us. Thank you so much.